I think we may just begin then? Question mark?
Yeah, sure. I'm ready when you guys are.
I mean,
Answer mark?
if he said he wasn't going to be here, then I suppose we should just ply on.
Ply on, yes, ply on.
Plow on.
Play on, airman.
Play on. That would be DC.
Pleb on. Or
Pleb
just.
on. Yeah, actually,
Or
that
basically,
suits me perfectly
what you
because I'm a
guys
massive
also can
pleb.
do, what you guys also can do is just die this time.
Wow, wonderful. That's nice of you.
What did I do to you?
That's just not nice, Miss Pierce. You can't be
You
professional.
killed my pineapple crew! What do you think?
And
I'm afraid
they started
to be
on
in the
us
banana
first.
business!
They started on us first. It's not our fault that we're short, like short green. You know.
Look.
You guys got
They
a
stole
blind woman.
our ring, so we destroyed their hole.
Their butthole.
Oh, that reminds me, Chris, I have got Final Fantasy 1 and 2 on my iPad.
Nice, man, nice.
Apparently, I had bought them about 3 or 4 years ago, and it keeps it on the cloud. And it's just like, oh, I've got Final Fantasy 1 and 2. So I might do
Well,
that.
good.
I'll try. I'll see how things go. But,
Anyway,
right.
There is no see, there
happened
is only
last
try.
week on the Golden Tip.
Just the tip!
The golden tip.
The Golden Tip. Remember that,
The
guys?
Of the tip.
golden tip. That would also be known as the end
Just
of Gold Member's
the tip,
penis.
Miss Perry. Just the tip.
Where's
No,
Shadow?
Before you bite
Really?
I want the
Oh my
golden
god.
tip, okay?
The one time I can get a joke for Shadow and he's got his fucking mic muted. You asshat! Damn!
He's a
Fucking.
twisted asshat.
Son of a.
Typical Shadow.
Son of a bitch.
Pentacles.
No, that's Japanese.
I've seen enough hentai to see where that's going.
Oh, I've seen enough
Penai!
hentai to see where this one's going. Start running, boys.
So you guys are
Right.
there.
Yeah, we're here. So, okay. Last week, the golden tip. We ended up speaking to a massive golden dragon after I think about 2.5 hours of. Oh, it was only 2 hours because I was really, really fucking tired last week, so I kind of cut it
Yes.
short. So we had gone from the city, which if I just where's my mouse? There it is. We came from the city, which is the mazy looking doodle over here, to over here, which we learned about a big golden dragon. We went in thinking, oh shit, we're gonna have to kill it, and then it turns out we could speak to it, and it was actually quite nice.
Yes, it was a nice dragon.
She was actually friendly,
which
wasn't
is
she?
very strange and rare
Have you
to
guys
find because they
noticed
normally just want to eat
about
you.
her age?
Is 1 million years old.
Her age?
If you would actually fight her, you'd all be dead by now.
Oh, fuck.
So she's a thousand dragon?
It was an ancient
MCI, sure. I've passed by enough adult-themed literature shops to know where this is going. You mean that little place underneath your mattress that you keep putting your hand into and pulling out all your literature?
He only reads them for, he only reads
Reason
them
for
for the
the
articles.
articles. I've still got those ankle supports on from playing softball earlier on, and I feel amazing. It's fantastic because I've been having it's like, as you know, I've got a metal plate in my ankle, and normally when you walk, your ball the ball socket joint in your ankle moves like up and down, like or forward and back. Even sorry, mine sort of goes in towards the leg a little because of the like breaking my ankle. And it's been sore walking recently, but this has made things a lot easier. So, I'll probably be wearing that a lot more. You can barely tell it's
What
there.
Are we doing?
Well, we've talked to the big big purple dragon, big golden dragon. Sorry.
Yeah, we talked to Barney.
I love you. You love me. I'm going to turn you into a toasty because I'm a big gold dragon. I don't like your face.
You're gonna turn into comatose.
I'm gonna turn you into comatose, children.
Yay! I remember, like, joke that people always used to make about one of the Barney songs, like the intro one.
Is that the "I love you"?
This can
you,
only
oh.
go so well.
It was like,
Barney is a dinosaur.
Barney the dinosaur
my
comes from imagination.
Yeah.
Shove some fireworks up his ass, and he'll live with constipation.
Oh,
Let's tie
wow.
Barney to a tree.
Oh god, was it is a stag night?
Poor Barney.
Is it, no, we're just gonna kill him. But, oh, okay. Did anyone notice that 2 days ago, on Friday, the 22nd of June, July, June, July, June, July, that July. The producer of Rick and Morty put a tweet out.
Oh, did he?
What'd he do?
I wasn't on Twitter.
Just updating of people where they are. Slightly delayed, but there will be a premiere of season 3 this year.
Nice, nice.
Mm-hmm. I've been rewatching it, so I decided to have a look, like, Rick and Morty news, and that was the first thing that popped up. And I was just like, oh, that was really good news!
Stuff to punch, stuff to kill, let's go.
Yes, so we have got one person down, unfortunately, because Greeny is not here. So
two persons, actually. Okay, two. The Madman was actually...
Oh, shit, Madman as well, yeah, fuck. Right, so we're
for
two
now,
people down.
The law behind them is that Greeny passed out from masturbating too much, and we can't afford to wake him up.
Madman actually went mad. Madman actually went mad.
He went mad. Punched a wall and his arm is now stuck in the wall, so he has to remove himself from it.
He punched it that hard, he is in pat. He's now just as fat as Nick Joe was. He hit the wall so hard, it melded. His fist is now stone. He's standing up like, well, this is a fucking, how do you do it?
Shit.
Well, it's like what happened when Murky was punching the spiders. He punched the wall so hard that his fist went into the second dimension and became paint on the wall.
Oh,
and
God.
Now he's just stuck there trying to pull it off.
I forgot about the spider we sent into the second dimension. I forgot
it
about that.
It just was the spider.
Woo! Rick and Morty! Hello, Dino. How you doing?
Maybe that's where the spider came from in Brick's house.
Oh, punched it so hard.
Wait,
you, from the imaginary
in
dimension.
There's
a spider.
Oh,
yeah,
my God.
Bunker.
Piercy, and, you have not been told about this, right?
I think this happened about a week after that.
Last week, I was going to put my green screen up, and as I took it off the chair and opened it up, this big ass spider.
I'm sorry.
I'd have to find the picture.
Fuck this shit, I'm out.
Would you look at the picture if I find the one?
No, yeah. She probably would.
You would?
I would scream though, but I
so basically, Murky punched the spider so hard that it fused into the wall, went through a portal, and into Brick's living room.
Do you what? I typed in legitimately Northern Ireland spiders, and it's the very first motherfucker.
I remember this.
Uh oh.
For anyone who's interested in the chat, there it is. There, that is the that's Egbert. The Provo
Egbert.
Spider.
Egbert
the Provo Spider. He does not have his boots on there. He does have 8 Doc Martens. Yes, I know they cost quite a lot. but that's what he used his dough money for. He likes to play the tin flute at 4 o'clock in the morning whilst sporting the tune The Sash, whilst goose step stomping across the floor.
Yeah, those legs are nearly as thick as the fucking body.
So I literally opened it up very slowly, and it just kind of goes onto my hand. I go... Literally, the girliest fucking scream. The thing learned to fly. It flew over and hit this wall over here. And then I'm like, oh, fucking touched me. Oh, I'd see. The thing is, I don't mind spiders. It's just the ones that just have, you know, the jump scare.
Pokemon?
That's the one that gets me. So I was trying to put the green screen up. It decided, oh no, I'm just going to crawl up the wall and get back on top of these curtains where I had my green screen. To which it decided, as I was putting it up, you know when you sort of like put your hand around the door like one finger at a time? Or like you grab something, it's just like, yeah, that thing decided to come around like one of the loops, but the wee legs just kind of went, dee, 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 dee. I was like, fuck, 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 fuck.
We're talking about a giant spider.
But once again, it probably learned to fly.
Yeah. So, it
new kind of Pokemon.
It then decided to sort of drop down, and I normally drink a bottle of Coke. So I had literally just taken a drink out of my Coke, and you know what happens when you sort of like you squeeze the bottle and then you leave it, the fizzy shit, when that is in the bottle, obviously it continuously releases and it will then push all dents out of the Coke bottle. The Coke bottle decided to make a sound, to which I shit myself and turned around and was about to fucking punch a hole through the wall, because it's just like, fucking spider, oh god. that was the rat.
Okay, guys, we are basically delaying this for another 30 minutes.
Oh, yeah.
Because we're talking about freaky, giant-ass, creepy crawlers.
We're talking about Egbert.
That's Egbert.
Egbert.
He doesn't pay rent, but, you know, he helps with the flies. So, I mean, you know, it's
But he's big and scary.
He's That's a how fucker. He pays his rent, by killing flies.
Yeah.
He would actually make me scream if I see him in real life.
You know what? I tortured my mum with that. In our old house, those things used to run across the floor quite a lot, because it was a big house, and apparently they like living in the attic. Mum would never, yeah. ever go in the attic. It was hilarious. But they would just, every so often, they'd like, you wouldn't see them, but they'd come down the chimney, and then you'd just see it come out onto the hearth, and it'd run across the floor. So you'd see this little thing just going, and Mum's just like,
that was very reminiscent of the Foxy scream.
Oh, and then she'd run.
Almost the R2-D2 scream break.
But yeah, mum does not like ones.
Fucking Foxy scream up in this bitch.
Used to do a lot better. But anyway, D&D! So, we were talking to the dragon and... she told us to go somewhere to get something of some sort somewhere?
Yes. If you look to the nice school, it's right here.
It's behind the school.
It's right in these somewhere.
Oh, in yeah, because before I was just like, I'm really tired, let's end it. We were talking about walking across, so we'll have to get... we had horses, didn't we?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so we'll get the horses and head
no
around.
One comments
about what getting a hand job around the back of the school.
We're meeting someone behind the school for a quick blow.
Well, I mean, the headmaster's not going to blow himself, and I want A's. lucky she's female, and blowing her doesn't make much sense. So we'll get in the horses.
Maybe she's a hermaphrodite.
This is true, but then you literally tell her to go fuck herself. Hey!
All right,
Ben, slop. Like, wait, hold on. How is that making... Do you want actually... let's just record it, put it on RedTube, make some money, and I don't want to think about it ever again.
Every time there's money... Oh, wait.
It's like, oh, yeah, there's another £500. Where'd that come from? Oh, yeah.
Okay, let's not talk about it again.
My mind warped. I don't understand. It's like dividing by
that
zero.
That sounded so different. There's
Right, so we need to get on our horses because our horses are amazing.
Look at my horse. My horse
is
amazing.
I'll give him a lick.
Give it a lick.
It tastes just like raisins. So we have to then make our way hastily to Shunra.
Really?
High.
It might just taste like horsehair.
Or, well, he's got a point there. Or as I like to call it, pig spots, because we made up a fake Hogwarts, so it's pig spots. So we're going to pig spots behind the school
to get a quick
blowy and have a fag, and find out what we're supposed to find. Right. Yeah.
So what route
there's three
are you
variations.
Guys going to take?
There's Hogwarts, there's pig pimples, and there's swain spots.
Are you going to take the normal routes, this one?
If we take the road, it means that we're not going to get attacked. Well, sorry, let me rephrase that. We'll have less of a chance to be attacked. If we go through the mountains and then take across the rough area, it'll take roughly about the same time as it would to go along the road, but it's in a straight line, but we'll be more likely to be attacked. So,
yeah.
Considering...
It's more fun, let's go this way.
Considering Murky is, getting, pretty full up on, bloodlust, I think we should probably head across off through the mountains and see if anything attacks us so we can,
don't think my music can calm Murky down anymore.
I don't think that might be smart.
Oh.
Well, we're doing it anyway.
Murky wants to kill things, so let's
kill. Yeah, well, I don't think Murky wants to die, does he?
See, that's the problem. We have no healer. No one decided to go healer.
Fuck it, we'll do it live. I'm the healer.
Well, technically, we are live, so...
Well, we are, yeah. So fuck it, we'll do it now. Oh, no, we'll do it now.
What about Phoenix? Maybe she's a healer or not. You never asked her.
Phoenix, darling, are you a healer?
Oh, Patsy, darling.
Patsy, darling. Come on, then, Patsy.
She hits you in the face.
Sorry, absolutely fabulous. I know exactly what he's talking about.
She is a little bit hormonal.
Oh, God. Is that what the wings are for? So when they go blood red, don't talk to her for a week. When they go white again, it's fine. If only all girls were that easily to understand. It could be they're just
the
be hungry. It could just be they're on their period. It could be that someone's really fucked them off. And if someone mentioned that they're on their period, it's going to send them off into flying range. Range? Rage. So at least, if you had big
wings...
It's
going to send them off into a flying punch fit.
Yeah, it, you know, it'd make more
literally,
sense.
Literally, they'll just spin and fly across the room, fists flying everywhere.
If I give you some advice, you might take the normal words.
Right, I think I'm going to take... Do you know what? I'm going to take the DM's advice, as not all DMs are as nice as that. Irish is a cunt. Sorry.
I still vote we go across the gap.
He killed my character and took my shits and giggles necklace. Unforgivable. So I think we will. I will take the DM's
let's
advice.
Let's take votes for who wants to go across the gap.
Okay.
And who doesn't.
Let's just take the safe route.
Vote for safe route. I say yeah. Aye. So that's one.
Aye.
Two.
Aye.
Three. Three majority rules. So it is. It is across the beaten path. That's not okay. That is not a euphemism for wanking all the way home. It's called a beaten path because people walk along it, not beat off on the path. Amount of times I stood, the amount of time you go through cobblestone streets and there's just cum in between all of it. Thank you very much, Luce. I appreciate it, dude. Cause we all love our brick. How are you doing, dude? But yeah, I think we should be taking the path. So we, how long would it take? Is it 2 weeks? I think we had this thing where we were getting rations last time, was it?
Mm-hmm. That was just to the dragon, but...
Oh, yeah, so, okay.
Are we
so
gonna starve?
Yeah, because no. We only got enough to go there, we didn't think about coming back. It took us 2 weeks to get there, and then we're like, oh.
Oh,
shit. We didn't think about going anywhere else or coming back. We're going to die now.
Right,
fuck.
Don't worry, we can just steal Murky's rations because he doesn't know what he has anyway.
Hey, Murky, try this. Like, what is it? We don't know. You're testing it first. Well, that's not... Oh, it makes your tongue swell up. That's what those berries do. Shut up, you're blind and you can't talk now. You literally are no fucking use. Ow! Okay, yeah, he can still hurt. That hurt.
Oh, wow, you can't hear either. Great.
Wait, is he meant to be going a funny shade of purple? Oh, that looks like a kidney. Oh.
Oh, look, he flies away.
No, that's his spirit. He has, in fact, died. Quick, get the comatose!
Word of
just
the
all,
day.
All of a sudden, he eats the comatose and be like, oh, that's much better. I feel revived. And then he just like lamps the. It's just like, who handed me them berries? Berries? Barry Allen. who handed me them berries? And be like, it was MCI. We'll blame it on MCI. I know he doesn't have a character, but now he does. It's like blame Robert. Blame MCI for it. So he just nukes him with one punch. Just. So
and then there's just fallout everywhere.
Oh yeah, I mean Fallout Boy, you know the Fallout, the bubblehead Fallout man, you know,
yeah.
The, with the thumb up thing.
The yeah, Fallout.
He doesn't have a fucking
okay,
thumb small enough.
Okay, legitimately though, do we have enough rations to get over there?
Have we got time to stock up?
What we'd have to do if we didn't have enough rations is we'd have to head back to the town, get rations, and then continue because yeah, there are no towns between.
You're saying?
You have enough rations for 4 days now.
How long will
it take us to get to the school?
It took us 2 weeks to get to where we are now, so we're pretty much fucked.
How long will it take us to get to the town?
2 weeks.
Less than 2 weeks.
Less than 2 weeks. Okay, 10 days.
Right. Can I do a nature check to look for rations in the forest or in the mountains or something?
Once again, if you find anything, give it to the blind one first just to make sure it's not poisonous.
No, Miss Pierce, is that enough rations for 4 days per character? Or in total?
I could just imagine. What's this? Just eat it. Smells like shit. Just eat it. Oh, God, what is this? It tastes like shit. It is shit.
We have enough for it. We have enough rations for 2 weeks.
Yeah,
oh God, the consistency of shit is. Yeah, it kind of is.
So would we have enough to get to a close town and stock up on rations before moving forward?
Are there any towns in the vicinity of 4 days worth of travel in any direction?
No.
Bollocks.
So we would have to ration out like one rat.
Can we ration our rations so that if we ate half of it? That it would last twice as long, so instead of 4, it would last 8 days, but we would be, like, really, really hungry.
Did you know that there's some elven bread in there?
There's what?
Elven bread.
Right.
Quick, don't let me go see it. I'll throw it off the cliff.
Let me just explain it. Okay. Ever watched The Lord of the Rings?
No.
It's been a while. Quick, hide it from Gollum. He's going to throw it off the cliff, guys.
If I remember correctly, elvish bread lasts quite a long time.
Yeah.
So you take a bite of it and it lasts a while.
Yeah.
Right, okay. So basically,
I'm going to
ask it's like...
One more time, though. Can I do a nature check to look for extra food?
DM?
You can.
Go for it! Get to one stab's foot. I think these are the right berries.
You
find those are your toes.
Greymack, why are you turning blue?
Greymack, you only found a few berries, not enough to get around.
No mushrooms?
Uh-huh. Oh, hold on. What we can do, use the berries to trap an animal, and then I was going to say something else there. Oops. We're going to eat it. Eat the rabbit if we can catch one. Because we're not MCI's Padar. We're not going to rape the shit out of it. And then use it as a condom. It's not a mastiff, so he can't wear his pants. Like, he can't wear it as pants. So he can
I
just sort of like.
This.
It's just, he's I just like. Can we rabbit him?
Poor bunny rabbit.
Hey guys, look what I can hold up with this! Oh god! Ah! Hey, do you like that cat, bitch?
I didn't think that rabbits could make that kind of noise.
So have you never heard like a really pissed off rabbit?
No,
those things sound like they sound violent as shit. Like no one thinks that turtles can make noises, but have you ever heard one fucking?
Oh yes, that video is funny as fuck.
The amazing time of the internet for what was about 2 months, where everyone was like turtle penis, blah, turtle penis, blah. So apparently turtles do make a noise, which is. right, so, with this elvish bread stuff lasting slightly longer, does that mean that we can have more than 4 days of travel?
Yeah, you can, basically what you can do is travel back to the city.
Hold on a second, I need to open this window. You know, today has been stupidly fucking warm, but it's like really humid.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ, I went up to the shop and I went, oh my god, it's either going to rain or I'm going to walk home and swim.
Playing softball today, I was absolutely dying. It's like heat stroke, but it was like every time you moved anywhere, it was like walking through the heat. It was disgusting and horrible. It was like really annoying. Right, so we can make it back to the city.
You can make it back to the city and get some more rations.
Right, let's head to the city and plan ahead this time and get twice as many rations that we need, just in case we get lost, stabbed, dead, or comatose.
Hey, look, they're comatose.
Quick, get the comatose! Why? Just if you break it up, put it in his mouth, he comes out of the coma. But that's stupid. Oh, I'm putting, like, fly farts and dog shit together to make a fucking fireball. Listen, shut up, wizard. You aren't a doctor. I'm gonna cast a cloud of blades. That's glass. Shut the fuck up. It's a joke because of the...
What have you been talking about?
Like, cloud of daggers. You need a sliver of glass. It's not a fucking dagger then, is it? It's glass. It would be a cloud of glass.
No, like everything.
Cloud of daggers.
Oh yeah, we were looking for new food because we were running out of rations, and we were going to get your character to try eating it first to make sure it was safe for us.
Oh right, you fucking.
You weren't listening to any of that.
No,
Oh wait, no, I know what you were doing. You were doing this sort of like, you weren't listening, but you're sort of like everyone stopped talking for a second. Like, So which he doesn't realize that at one point we fed him dog shit.
I heard that.
Oh, that's
well, God, it's I assume, what is it? Just eat it.
I assume that it's dog shit.
It tastes like shit as well. Oh, what is this consistency? What the fuck have you fed me?
Shit.
But it's quite nutty.
It's quite nutty. Oh, this coffee smells like shit. It is shit, Austin. Oh, good, then it's not just me. Oh, it's a bit nutty. He's got his fucking lip.
possible.
Absolutely fantastic movie. Anyway, let's make actual headway. Head to the city.
Don't worry, I can help you with headway.
As you
look, we know you're a stripper, but I'm not interested. $20 for the lap dance, not a lap suck. Thank y'all.
As you guys head to the city, you see that the sites, like any forest or anything, are completely gone.
Forests?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, with the way this kind of looks right now, it's pretty much desert.
It looks desert.
Yeah.
But this is now how it looks like right now.
So it's all desert?
It's all desert now.
Do we have enough water?
Which town did we go to?
Oh.
Big maze looking one or Shanor?
The maze one.
The maze.
Someone move the We Are Here.
Well, we haven't actually moved yet because Piercy kind of has to do rolls.
You've been
and
talking
stuff.
About food and feeding me dog shit. That's been for half an hour.
I'm actually trying to introduce you to doing. A new maze.
Just
town.
When he says it! Just when he says it! This is me arguing about food and feeding me dog shit!
Like, where did we go? I don't know
but here, eat this one as it chased it. Oh god, not again. Like, twice, seriously.
Right, who are we meant to be talking to? Because
we haven't actually figured that out yet. We have to go to the city to get rations to be able to get to Shanor High. so we need to start moving, head over to the Maze Town or whatever the big town was called. Did you give it a name?
It's called Maze Town.
Maze Town, okay.
Because it's actually, if you zoom in,
it is a labyrinth.
It looks like a labyrinth.
Where's
where?
Oh,
it's
there.
Right here.
Beside the ship on the left hand side.
Right, okay.
So,
as Techie and Labyrinth.
That's a puzzle from a fucking newspaper. That's not a town.
Puzzle?
we have to get from the outside to the center. They used to have them in, like,
Or from the center to the outside.
From the center to the outside. They had them in newspapers, like, with the...
That's not the town! That's something you found on the back of a cereal box!
That as well, they're on the back of cereal boxes.
Grey Mech, it was made in the back of a cereal box. Don't be nasty to Pierce, come on now.
Hey, I made this whole campaign out of the back of a cereal box,
and
okay?
In fairness, and I'm very sorry, Greeny, but that's still better than your maps.
Well, in fairness, the way we laid out the main bit of the original map was at least somewhat...
The middle of it was all water, and then it was just, like, area.
Like, originally when we made it, I thought, oh, it's just going to be an island. It's like, no, I'm like, oh, so the middle bit's water? That's
it's
fucking
a
weird.
It's a giant lake that was sort of the sea, but not the sea. Don't know how or why, but we won't question it. So, we're heading back to the town.
You're heading back to the town, and as you are in front of the... doors of the town, you see that the whole town has been burning for quite some time.
Oh, cock.
I thought we were here already.
No, you were talking about feeding me dog shit, not on the way there.
So right now you're
we're
just
there.
Like,
then
we're
traveled.
We're here at the new Pokey travel watch thing.
Yeah. We're flying on the giant one of those. Or it's levitating, it's one of the two.
Just turn it sideways, it looks like a fish with no fins and just one eye.
Tadpole!
Do you want it?
Oh, that's red tadpole.
It's just a really melted eyeball. The person got really stoned beforehand.
Oh my god, it's Misty's gym badge after she went emo.
It's an upset one now.
Really? It just like you give it like an emo bang, an emo flick kind of thing going on there?
If you look at it as if
it's
it
a sad
sideways,
face.
It's a sad face.
So
or
it is.
If you look at it the other way, just a really angry looking eyebrow.
It's just really pissed. We don't know, is it sad or angry? You know, it's like most girls' eyebrows these days when they paint them on. I don't understand. Are you angry? Or are they trying to fly away? Where are they going?
Are those actually your eyebrows, or are those just slugs that are crawling across your face?
You know when they've done that really bad, and it's just like, it's literally like, you know, like that?
You know, guys, if we were doing this at an actual table, I would actually stand
We'd all
up
be getting
and
slapped.
Hit all you guys on the back of your head. And yeah.
Stop it,
not
stop it,
the
stop
soft
it, stop
way.
It.
Oh, I love that, Miss Bear.
That's only because you're a masochist.
Kinky fucker.
Damn right.
Right, come on. Those are going to be painful.
Okay, so the town is on fire.
Yes, and people are basically panicking.
Everyone's. I'm not surprised everyone's panicking. Everything's on fire.
I mean, no. Obviously, when my town's on fire, I sit down and have a fucking cup of tea.
Gino, hold on. If who can find that meme?
Oh, the little girl.
Do continue, Piss, while we're blabbering on about stuff.
Well, people are panicking, and one person grabs you, Murky, and says, "It was here," and then runs away.
That's the one I'm talking about.
Yeah.
That's what's happening, right there. That's what's happening. Someone's just been like, "It's fine. I can deal with this." Hello, Axel. How you doing, dude? Welcome in.
This is basically Murky's character right now.
Wait, what?
Except you forgot that she's, you know, she's blind, but you know, whatever.
No, that's Phoenix.
No.
True.
This is my person right now.
Oh God. Here we go again.
Ball! What is it?
Okay, Pete.
Peter Griffin, so... blind in the bar where he saves the guy.
Oh, God.
Okay, so everything's on fire and everyone's panicking. Which we have, you know, deduced that it is a normal thing to do. So, you know.
Yeah. They run to the blind person, say it was here. I'm sort of like, okay, yeah, thanks. What's it?
Everything's on fire.
She already ran away.
You just sort of stand there, but guys, have a question. What's fire?
Thinking, yeah, and they tell the blind person that something's here. Wonderful.
It's big, red, and burning.
I can smell burning and hear screaming. Telling me that it is here is not a good sign for me.
It has arrived. Oh, Gwynny's replied.
Oh, really?
I run into the town and look for survivors to try and help them.
I'm just sort of just gonna sit here and... I can't watch it burn. That doesn't work.
Some people just want to watch... Oh, stand there with no eyes and feel the word burn.
Some people just want to stand and watch the word burn. What about me?
You can just feel the heat and be happy.
You sort of hear the screams of people and just really like be happy.
So all you can hear is like screaming and your son are smiling.
You know what? Your guys blabbering about all kinds of shit is actually pretty nice right now because you guys aren't actually talking about shit.
Oh yeah, how is your mouth? Does your mouth still taste like shit?
Oh God.
You made that one happen, Pierce. You reminded me about it. So what do we do?
The worst part is, Murky, he doesn't know that what's actually happening here. Like, for all he knows, he's standing in a sauna with the soundtrack of people screaming playing in the background.
Yeah, scream it, because that's very likely to be happening right now, isn't it?
I'm pretty sure he goes to sleep with that.
As far as you know.
He just goes to sleep with the sound of screaming. It's just people screaming non-stop for like 8 hours.
But I don't go to sleep with the sound of it. That's just the crazy voices.
Oh dear lord.
People,
he prefers the sound of screaming than the sound of silence.
The hills are a sound!
What the fuck?
What you guys are
The hills are a hearing? Sound. The hills are a sound of the life
the
of music.
The hills are alive with the sound of
screaming.
Chaos.
Yes, miss?
What you guys actually hear is the screaming of people.
Well, I hope it's people.
Yeah.
Crying of children and babies.
Don't say that, Murky's gonna get a boner.
This character's female!
Yeah, he's gonna get a lady boner.
Look, but dude, all you need is like enough force and his lady boner will poke through his zipper.
Dude, that's where he's really punching people with.
What you see are also a lot of dead bodies.
Because I've opened this window, it's banging every so often.
Hey, no, but what people sort of see is lots of dead bodies.
It's annoying me because I keep thinking there's someone Murky. There, but there's
no one.
Then what Murky sees is just blackness.
The only thing you see is blackness and you actually smell of decaying bodies.
Are there any people around that are A, not in fire, and B, could talk to us since they aren't that badly burnt, their mouths have kind of melted over.
Not I'm really. Still in there looking for survivors and trying to help.
I'd say go and have a look. Not me, but you guys go and have a look. And see if there's anything.
Can I do a perception check to see if I find any survivors? Still.
Apparently Greedy said someone told him that D&D wasn't on.
Who?
Dunno. Just says Wolf goes D&D. Greedy says you said it wasn't on. Wolf, at this moment, Greeny knew he fucked up. Greeny, yeah, I was at the cinema. Wolf, let me guess, Star Trek. Greeny, Wolf, it was good. Wolf, did they pay the respects? And they... fucking talking about Star Wars now. Or Star Trek, even, sorry.
So, right, so Greeny's out of the cinema.
He's just out of the cinema. So he will probably turn up, which means he will snap out of his insanity and find us and join us in our quest.
He'll wake up covered in jizz and he'll find his way over here.
Like, why do you smell this? Like, hey guys, why do you smell like cum and how can I figure that out 50 paces away?
I will know when he's on the way here because I will smell him from a mile off.
Oh god. He's been walking, he's already fell over in the cobblestones where all the cum sort
of
like...
No, it's mostly because he's sweating.
He's cum!
Oh
he's
my
that
god.
Worked
oh, man, that's... I thought it was bad when you did exercise and you got man smell or woman smell. You know, just general body odor. But when you start working out and you smell like cum...
And pineapple.
Questions are going to be asked.
Right there, man.
Because could you imagine that? Be like, yes! Oh, God! And everyone just be like, oh my God, is someone fucking in the showers? Like, literally, like legitimately, like, spaffing every 3 seconds? It smells like... It's like I could get pregnant from breathing! It's horrible! the smell's airborne. Is the sperm airborne? Get the fuck away from me. I felt like I was getting more protein from somewhere.
Then that's what I call being hot and bothered.
Oh, God. Ooh, anyway, let's talk, talk of sperm being going up your nostrils.
To see if I find survivors.
Sure. Well, if anyone else wants to do that, then...
Perception.
I find a shit ton of survivors, and when I run
perception
over to them, the ceiling collapses and they
perception.
All die.
Because Braymac basically didn't find anything.
I found them. I found, like, all the survivors in the town, but as soon as I approached them, just the entire... Like,
it comes down
explodes.
To the fact where the blind person finds more people than the people who can actually see.
Well, that's like saying...
That's
right,
just because you're tripping over them.
But, I mean, that's
why
like saying, like, let's send this Mexican into the mine
Chris,
and see if he can sniff out all the miners.
Wisdom,
like, no, how about we get the sniffer dog to
in
do
skills,
this? But, no, the Mexican's got it.
Like, there's core stat skills background. Click the skills tab and perception's on the right-hand side.
Oh, find it. Thank you.
It's a pain.
Okay,
it's a bit of a pain.
Coming. Okay, Murky and
Greeny's not
actually. No, he's not coming.
Oh,
Murky and Chris actually.
Hold
found
on a second.
Some...
I can hear banging of feet upstairs.
That's fine. Well, that's going. We find
some surviving children who lost their parents.
Oh, poor kiddies.
Yeah, and actually also
kiddies,
a baby.
She says, and she's about to slaughter
and
them
Bobby.
All.
And Bebe, who got left behind.
No, not the Bebe.
The Bebe.
I was mistaken, it must be next door, because there's no doors and nothing upstairs. So,
so
we found
a bunch
asleep.
Of kids and a Bebe.
A bunch of kids and a Bebe.
Yeah, a baby.
And Murky says,
behind.
Oh, the poor kiddies. Slaughter them all.
Just fucking eats them.
About
I needed to get that taste of shit out of my mouth. A newborn is a fantastic way to get shit out of your mouth. How do you know this? Like, shut up, I'm blind. Like, did you mistake a newborn baby for a loaf of bread?
People makes mistakes.
Did you not wonder why the toast was moist and screaming? No. Oh my god! I am such a horrible person!
You really are.
You're eating the wrong toast.
Did you not wonder why the toast is moist and screaming?
Rick is just...
User disconnected from your channel.
Oh, I broke him. Oh my god, please someone make that a quote. Make it a quote.
I'm sorry, bro. Your laugh is just so funny.
I'm sorry. Oh my god,
what are
I love
you sorry
it.
For?
Oh, because that is absolutely fucking disgusting, but it's hilarious.
Only brick. Only brick.
Oh my god. Is Luce just getting the other end of that now?
I don't know.
Oh my god. Is
He's
it,
getting a beer, it's not the other end, but...
Is it... How do you do this? Quote... Add...
Right,
so we found a baby and some kids.
A baba and some...
So we're just hope and pray that we don't happen to find a toaster.
Go make sure take care of them, because otherwise I'm going to Anakin.
No!
Them. Oh, trust me.
I go up and help
you,
the children.
You leave them in my capable hands. Is that all going to be dead fast and then I can kill the Padawans?
Padawans?
I remember, you remember that movie where Anakin killed all those kids?
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Oh,
yeah, that will happen with me.
Yay, look, I did it! It worked!
Probably someone more capable than me in looking after kids.
Chris!
What? I'm going to take care of the
stop
kids.
Stop him!
Oh, God.
I ask if any of them are injured.
Just look after the kids.
Grimmick, you didn't found any.
Grimmick, you're
I'm
blind
next to Murky.
Look at your perception.
Is this
Chris is the other one that found
the kids. Oh my god, it's yeah. The surf like, I found the kids!
Well yeah,
where?
I may not be able to find the kids, but I still know where you are.
They're right in front of you. Where? I can't see them. Are you blind? No, I just can't perceive things very well.
I'm the one that ticks the box of blind on this fucking
thing. So, pretty much, we're letting the blind character go find more children while I look after other ones.
Yes. By the signs of things.
If he wants
all right,
to do that,
I walk over to Chris
to
help
perception
then.
Perception check.
I would have to do more perception. I will
more
fail.
Perception.
Oh shit! He pulls a 25 out of his ass.
All
you
the kids.
Oh my god, yeah, I need that.
Dude, you searched so well. You found Anne Frank as well. Hitler couldn't find her for ages. A blind woman finds her like that.
I found the kids.
Hitler was looking after the war. Looking and looking, blind woman.
Oh, oh sorry. God, open
found
like
it.
A new tab.
Take the first one, just.
Typical.
Yeah, I was following Murky.
What the fuck is that?
Okay.
What the fuck is that?
I'm gonna take care of the ones that Murky just found, because otherwise it's not going
it's
to end
well. It's a
fat guy
in a fedora tipping a hat, and it's intensifying.
Looks like he's having some sort of seizure. Man, too much fedora's making me.
Chris,
yeah.
You have found a panicking woman trying, who is basically trying to save all the kids.
That's more like it.
There we go.
Dave, or do you mean take all?
I think I found one.
Save.
No, that was a wall.
Right, Brick, do another perception, and Graham, do another perception, because I've done two, and Chris has done two.
Oh God.
I found them!
Grimmick found someone, Brick is still fucking clueless.
I found a shoe! Do we need to save
it's
shoes?
It's your own shoe.
Oh wait, shit. Yeah, it's children, not shoes we're looking for. Fuck! No, not
no,
only that,
for
that
the
was
children,
your...
not the shoes
actually,
that they
wear.
My
shoes.
Bad.
I don't know. You have hooves, don't you?
Grimmick,
Brick, she's like, okay, I found the shoes, now you find the children to fill them.
That's true, I just sort of like wraps around the sort of like second pair of ankles.
Can I tell this panicking woman to stand back while I go save some more children?
Stand here, it's like she's hysterical, like stand here and wait.
You
like,
can
no, stand there and wait. Stand there and wait.
Can I backhand her, knock her right, and then go save the children?
Right,
or I can just put her to
finding
sleep.
Kids?
Oh yeah, Grimmick could just like
so
put music.
So basically what you guys are doing are
fucking that
found
again.
All the kids by now, and you need to get them out of the city.
Right. People get them out of the city. What do we want?
First, I check to see if any of them are injured.
Greymech, we can worry about if they're injured after
yes,
we get them
worry
out of the
about
burning,
the injured
collapsing
later.
City.
Let's
I love how
he
wants.
Right,
I love
fine.
How he wants to look and touch at the children to make sure they're not injured.
Don't worry, the bridge is collapsing. Let me check if you got any boo-boos first. Like, seriously, just get them
but,
out of the town.
Greymech, I know you need to recruit for your strippers. But still, come on.
I've heard of starting them young, but that's fucking ridiculous, dude.
Right, what do we roll to get them out? Do we roll to get them out of the city, or we just successfully get them out of the city?
You actually successfully get them out of the city.
Woo! Is that woman still hysterical?
I think she's dead.
No, she is still hysterical.
Can you give her a slap?
City.
You know, what,
I use
you know
charm person?
That?
Well, how do you know you're going back to get her?
I'm still standing there with you. When we got her, when we found her, she's like,
I'll grab her hand and just put her hand in your face so you know where she is.
Wonderful.
I just put her to sleep so that she's not hysterical?
Dude, it's the other child! Stop it! I'll take you over to her. Here, eat this. I'm like, no, dude, that's the other child. Stop it.
She is basically.
Oh, good, I've got some butter from my bread. Why is my butter screaming? Guys, that's not funny. Seriously, again.
Oh. There's more emos on the way. She said wolves.
Oh, God.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
So, do we have to defeat wolves now to stop them from eating the children?
Yay, wolves! I love wolves.
Oh my god, please make it just be like wolf's face.
No, we have to stop them before they keep spreading the depressing music.
I don't have any My Chemical Romance.
It depends if you want to go back into the city to see what's going on.
Well, I mean, it's on fire. I don't think it'd be such a great idea.
Can we wait till the fire burns itself out?
It's always fun to fight someone on a new battlefield.
Well, it's actually started to rain now.
Yay!
Well, it's gonna help.
Oh, that's gonna be. Actually, oh my god. Yes, that'll be hilarious.
Why?
He's now Daredevil.
This isn't really making much sense. I'm going to read her mind.
Wait,
her thoughts. Is that okay, Percy?
Wait, you're a bard. What? How the hell can you do that?
With this?
Oh, detect thoughts, okay. Isn't that sort of like what you're thinking? I'd be like, I wish that cunt would stay in my head. Oh.
Oh shit!
You knew? Of course I knew.
She is basically thinking, like thinking, are all the kids safe? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
All right.
12, 11, 10, 15, 17, 4, 3, 4, 8, 9, 2.
Shit!
Forgot count.
That was not even close to my debit card number, so don't even try and use that in my bank account.
Damn it!
Can you detect thoughts of anything else? Anyone else?
Well, I mean, it wouldn't be very good to do it to the children because they'd literally just be screaming internally.
It's like, guys, I'm not really getting much, just...
It's like, yeah, that's what we hear outside because that's what they're doing as well. That's worse, what you're doing and thinking
maybe
the same
thing.
Maybe
we should have put the fire out that's on their faces.
You know what? That probably would have been a good idea. But I mean, they kind of do look like punch jam right now, so we may want to leave it. Sorry. To quote Deadpool, their faces may look like if Freddy Krueger fucked a topographical map of Utah. I love that one. It's fantastic. God, looks like your face is like Freddy Krueger fucked a topographical map of Utah. Your face looks like an avocado that got fucked by an older and, like, worse avocado. Right, so, the children on fire, the woman's continuously screaming whilst thinking about counting...
The children are fine.
The children are
fine. Oh, okay. So we've just got a woman who's screaming and then counting
just
internally.
Just the woman that's, like, screaming her tits off.
Okay.
Us just trying to say, calm, your tits isn't happening.
Okay. Do we want to be the heroes and re-adventure... I just closed that fucking door. Re-adventure back into the city?
Yeah.
That's one for yes.
Yeah!
Two for yes.
Yes.
Three for yes. Majority rules. We go back into the city
to
see who we can save.
I'm just going to stay here with the kids and make sure they're safe.
That's actually a good point. Someone does need to stay with the children. I'm not Grey Mac because he's going to...
The least combat ready. So Grey Mac.
Fucking Grit. Well, shouldn't there be someone here to protect them considering, you know, wolves?
All right, Michael Jackson, calm down.
You have... Excuse me. You can still fight. I'm just not going to put you... If there's people in the city... And we have to fight in the city. You're not exactly great in combat or close spaces.
Well, yeah, but I'm a support character. I have to help you out.
But then who would stay with the kids?
Question. Phoenix.
Yes, what's with her?
Would she mind staying with the children?
Sure. She would
stay with the children. Or would she like to come with us? Because we can't just, you know, we can sit here and be like, right, there's five of us, one needs to stay behind with the kids, and then the four of us need to leave.
Well, basically, the group, Phoenix the bigger knows group who this is, and she doesn't want to get back into the city, so she'll stay with them.
Oh, wonderful. Perfect. Then we will go fight We'll go find whoever's left in the city, and if they're evil, we will kill them.
Yes. Or if they just get in your way, you're just going to kill them anyway, because that's just...
That doesn't sound good, Pierce. What's wrong?
This.
Oh my god, a black screen! Well, yeah, we know that. Here we have a map. As you can see, it's through Murky's eyes. He is blind, so it is a little bit of a touchy-feely.
Yep, scroll down. Don't worry. But this is what I am forced to see on a daily basis. It is completely pitch black.
See? You see fuck all. You imagine.
Yeah, I have to imagine. So.
This is freaking pineapples.
You guys entering the city.
Okay.
And while you are entering the city and you basically are walking.
I'm storming your citadel, m'lady!
Down the
walking
gate.
Forward.
Oh, walking that way, aren't you?
Well, I'm not walking backwards, hopefully. I figured that much out in my life that I can have the ability to walk forward.
Well,
you hear?
You believe.
Uh-oh. Oh, yay, puppies!
Oh, shit, guys, it's Entai. I said Entai.
Oh, my God.
See? Pokemon joke. He gets it because he plays Pokemon a lot and gets it.
It's funny because he says, look, guys, it's Entai.
Entei.
Instead of Entei.
Entei, I don't fucking Entei. Know. The flamey dog thing I can't pronounce. Hentai. No, Brick, that's the wrong one. That's where things. That's where the dogs open up the chests and tentacles come out and then fuck honest, things.
That's the thing.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Pokemon Go, and I called it Hentai.
I caught a tentacle.
I think
I'm totally naming it that.
A tentacle and named it Hentai.
I'm totally doing that.
Is it
I caught
okay
one
if
like
I
yesterday.
Just call it you guys.
You call it you guys?
Yeah, I just name it after you guys.
Oh, I thought you were saying like you. It's like, do you mind if I call it you guys? I'm like, what? You're ending it? Fuck! I didn't really piss you off that badly. Shit, sorry. right, so we've got some wolves. Are the wolves on fire?
Nope.
They will be because I'm going to set them on fire.
They are dire wolves.
Cuck.
Game of Thrones
right,
reference.
Straight off before we get anything started, there's my mage armor, so that's +3 to my AC straight away because I'm made of plastic. Sorry, no, I'm made of wet paper.
They're made of wet paper, so basically they don't pay any attention to you guys.
Murky,
right now.
Go kick out the bollocks. Yeah, go kick out the bollocks, it'll know then.
What you basically can do, guys, is sneak a little forward.
Or we could set Murky on them and rip them in half. Then we can get Padar from another universe to come and fuck the half that he leaves.
Or I can take one over.
Ooh.
Dude, take one over.
Hopefully they're brothers. Take one over and get them to fight each other. It's a battle of the death. Two brothers.
Yes, indeed. But they'll only fight each other for 1 minute.
Chris is moving forward, he... is this.
Oh, fuck! Chris,
oh,
you
shit.
Stupid shit, get the fuck back here!
Run away!
Jesus is like, nah, fuck this shit, nope. right, you'll have to go back up there, unfortunately,
now,
Chris.
Where's he gone?
If you want to know...
He's in front of you, but you know, you're blind, we'll let you
what
wear that.
This is...
It's a mage.
Guys, uh-oh. If you want to know what this isn't a mage. It's worse.
Necromancer.
Necrophage. It's like a combat mage.
It's a creature.
Oh.
It's kind
succubus?
Of. No.
Alright.
Can a succubus be?
Well, I can't see what it is.
Oh,
so
what's the name of that thing? There's a type of creature that commands direwolves, and I forget what it's called.
Nope. It's not that.
But it's got
is
a sword.
It just a vampire?
Is it
Ned Stark?
No.
Can you just fucking tell us?
It's just a token. It is actually a banshee.
Oh.
Oh, shit, a banshee. Right, okay. Can I
Oh, Dire Screams. I get it. Nice one, Percy. The name of this week's title.
Sounds like we want to go into a fight.
Well...
Every week, I make up a title
based on something
title...
in the actual campaign. Yeah. I like that. It took me a second. It's just like, it's a banshee. Dire wolves. It's like, dire screams. I get it. Genius. She's a smart one, this one.
Of course I am. I wasn't born blonde. Oh, actually, I was.
Well, it could be worse. You could be bored blind. Working. Well, I'm waiting for him to like, see when I find you, and I'm like...
It could be better. You could be born with pretty blue eyes and always keep them.
Ah, well, you know, there's always spoons in the drawer.
Wow.
Oh, so wait, no, guys... sorry. That's what happened to Murky. He lost a card game and spoons got involved. Never, ever bet silverware. Never. Okay, that's enough, Door. I am going to nail you shut if you keep creepily opening like that.
There's no one there, and if there is, fuck off, ghost. I'm not in the mood. I am playing D&D, you fuck.
That burp.
Says that freaking specter's been like, I'm going to open the door. I'm like, no, fuck off. I'm busy doing
D&D. It's really Rick, it's Edbert. He's opening the door.
Do you know what? I bet you it is Edbert. He's just kind of going, you fucking wanker.
Rick?
Yes?
If you don't like ghosts, just say you are not welcome here.
You are not welcome here.
No, properly, Rick.
One ghost one beast off.
Two nipples.
Three nipples. Ah, the fuck?
One nipple. Two nipple. Three nipple. Oh, hell no, I'm out of here.
Okay, so we have got a banshee and four direwolves, and the banshee can, in fact, I'm going to assume, command the direwolves?
Nope.
Oh.
Where we can command them or not doesn't matter. We kill the things, we kill the thing.
Okay, so turn order. Remember to click your person first and then tap initiative. Oh, I got a 12. Yay! Better than a fucking 6
or a
1.
Wait.
Waiting.
Greymack, Murky 8.
Initiative.
I have just remembered where all of my D&D dice are.
Oh really?
Uh huh.
I get them right here.
I've literally I was just thinking because I was like, I remember that I could hear you so like playing with them, and I was like, I wonder where mine are.
It again, went,
I remember where it is.
10.
Yeah. Okay. No, I roll initiative.
Yeah, girl, you're here.
I tried to, and it didn't work.
Well, that's just that's why I said click your character first, because that's why it will say.
I did, but I had my character sheet popped out in another tab, and I had to press F5 in the main one, and I forgot about it.
Ah. Oh. So we've got 10, 12, 11. Okay, so the four characters
Brit,
that are
Chris,
here.
Chris, me, Grey.
And then we will now see the four dire wolves and the banshee. We shall see how things go. And then tomorrow I will be looking into getting last week's D&D sorted, and I will be doing this week's as well. So expect at least 3 videos tomorrow on the YouTube.
B, D1, D2. Okay.
Makes life
easier.
Direwolf
1, Direwolf 2.
Yeah. It's a lot easier because I remember week we were having issues with multiple of the same things attacking us. We couldn't figure out which fucking one was what. So this makes life. This will make life a lot easier.
For the people in the chat that have not subscribed to Brickslayer's YouTube, there it is.
YouTube. You just have to do exclamation point media.
Shamelessly plugging.
Or if you want to hear my number hit one song in my head, Bumholio, please put in exclamation point bum.
Exclamation point bum.
Bumholio!
Descending, and...
This Sunday, Sunday, Sunday!
Senpai!
Yes?
Thy be first! What you gonna do? Brico
Senpai!
In front of you!
It's me that's first. 12!
Yeah, it's Brico Senpai.
Brick rolled the 12!
Jeez, look at Chris getting so full of himself, thinking Piercy was talking about him. God!
Other Senpai.
Right, let's see. If I remember rightly, Murky, I could...
Sorry,
like last Taco Tuesday, but anyway. Oh, yes, I know what I'm going to do.
I'm going for that Banshee whenever it's my turn.
30 feet. Okay, so if I move 20, I've got that 20. No, because the wolves are going to get me, so I need to be at least where one of you guys are sitting. Shit. Which one is Direwolf 4? That one?
That one, yeah.
Fuck, I knew it. I just had this feeling.
Wait, which
knew
one is it?
this one here.
It starts here. One.
Piercy, how do you do the ping thing?
Hold control and click.
Just hold that click.
3, 4.
Oh, cool.
I hold left click, it doesn't work. I press control. Do you know what's not working for me? I fuck
Sonar.
You. Right, okay, let's see. I was going to do that, but that puts me in a very awkward position. I want to get 27 health.
If you're the same height, you cannot go through the other person.
Well, I mean, there's like... I could sort of like squeeze past, and there's like... Is this like a path or like a town?
It's just a path. Oh, okay. Everything around it is open.
Alright, because what I was thinking is, I was going to move in front of these guys, but that kind of puts me in the target range from them too.
Mm-hmm.
That could work. That's still 30 feet. That would do. I'm going to do that. I'm going to hop up beside Murky.
Hang on. That's 10 feet to move to there, and then that is 25 feet.
And? What's your point?
What's your movement speed?
Who gives a shit? It's my range.
Oh. Oh, yeah, that's your range. Right, yeah.
I'm just moving 10. Oh. I have to just have it 30.
Because you're a magician. Right, I forgot.
Wizard! I don't pull rabbits out of hats unless I'm paid to.
Close enough to get a fucking magician.
And even then, he's actually creating the rabbits and not just pulling one that he already had pre-stored in the
Shut
hat.
Shut up, Dramione. Harry's the wizard.
Oh my god, Dramione. I forgot about that. That's amazing. I am going to do this on her. You ready?
Pow. Yeah, go ahead.
Octoscript. Hold on. Where's the that button? My bad. There we go.
Creature of your choice that you can see within range perspective. Everything has hilarious.
Gonna give a giggle fits. But...
Yeah, so basically we're just gonna say, hey, he thought it was bread, but he actually had a baby and asked why was the bread moist. See? And that's how that giggling would start, and then the banshee wouldn't be able to scream because it'd be laughing too much. Because banshee screams can stop people from moving. Ha ha ha! It's funny and smart at the same time. A little bit like QI.
Damn it.
See, I watch smart shows. I don't ever say so, because then that would ruin it that people think I'm an idiot. Well,
then
I am,
that
but that's not the point.
Turn. There is no...
A creature of your choice that can see within range has to do a wisdom saving throw or fall prone and laugh its tiny little bollocks off. A creature with an intelligence score of 4 or less is not affected. So what is a banshee's intelligence, then? That's a good point.
It's probably more than 4, I'd imagine, because it's not a rock.
True. Hey, rock! Do you want to hear a joke? This guy's no fun. Rock. He doesn't fucking talk back. Dwayne Johnson,
I'm
you're an asshole. Do you know
up
that?
For a second. A banshee intelligence is +1.
Is it just 1?
Is it the... Yeah. The wait, what? A banshee's intelligence is just 1?
It's in the book.
At the end of each of its turns and time each time it takes damage, the target can make another wisdom saving throw. So at the end of each of its turn and every time someone hits it, it can do another one. Hello, McWonderlama, how are you doing? Do you know what? I actually was kind of pissed at you because I made that fucking Amazon list and you haven't appeared for a week the day after I made it, you ass. I have to go fucking get it too because I don't have a link.
So
God damn it, McWonderlama! That's my movement and attack is to incapacitate the banshee as much as possible because it's going to be a big problem if she screams because that is just going to stop anyone from doing anything because we're going to be incapacitated. So if I incapacitate
except first, for me because I'm a bard.
Okay, when it says +1, that's not the score. The number that's not in the brackets is its score. So it has an intelligence of 12, but it's got a +1 to int because that's its modifier.
Oh, okay.
So it has it's got 1 strength, for example, but 12 intelligence. So she is affected by it. So she needs to do a wisdom saving throw.
Brick, thanks for fucking up my turn.
Saving throw.
Let me just
and there should be something in there that it has to score higher than.
I was planning to do something to the banshee, and thanks to you, I don't think it's a good idea anymore, Brick.
Well, I mean, the first thing I thought was to.
Fails the wisdom save, so
she
is
now on the floor, giggling her little balls off, and she can't do anything unless she breaks the wisdom throw. Breaks it, sorry, okay. Successfully.
I was just going to, you know, to completely take control of her, but whatever.
Well, you can do, but I mean, she just sort of lie there giggling.
But I won't be able to kill anything with her because she'll be laughing her ass off.
True.
That's why you can control the fucking wolf or something.
Get the, yeah, control a wolf, the one next to her,
or
to
in
go
the
and
meanwhile,
attack her.
Great, just fight the wolves, and if she snaps out of it, then control them.
Because, yeah, I mean, Mercury's just going to walk over there and, like, punch it right in the face, and
I,
the wolf's
I'm
just going to go...
I'm going to beat the shit out of everything that's not the banshee at the moment.
Yeah,
so.
It's just going to explode into guts. And then Pidara's gonna
so
come up and
Chris
start fucking
the one
the
that's right up next to it, right?
Yeah, that's my target.
Okay, I'm gonna wait and see who will be their turn after me.
I just think
it's
to
do.
To your right, your immediate right, just kill that one.
Well, if you want, you can always give me a burst.
Well, you attack before me.
Wait, hold on, what have I done here? Have I done something wrong?
What do you mean you've done something wrong?
Hotbitch HD PVR USB High Def H26 or 264 video capture device, high definition USB 2.0 video capture with hardware, H264 video encoders 3 out of 5 stars.
List?
Apparently it's £100,000 or one penny.
What?
Link me the thing.
Yeah, that's where I'm thinking.
Link me the list.
Have I done something wrong? Hello, Emily. How you doing, Grill? I hope everything's going well. So yeah, that's my turn done.
Which one?
The Hapage HD PVR USB high def video capture device.
Ranging from £96 up to that top one.
£100,000? I hope it records 4K porn for that!
For free?
Yeah, I mean, no, I mean, I hope I get it. There's already porn on it that's in fucking 4K for that price. That I get to sell, distribute, and make that fucking money back. Christ! Ah! That is ridiculous!
See, all buying options. There's only two buying options, and then there's... the two buying options of that. It's saying, like... Okay, the one that probably sold for that was a different, like... film-grade version of it, probably.
Okay.
That actually has
the ones that are there, one is $49.99 and one's $54.99. That's what those... If you want to see what they cost, just click the thing and do view buying options. And it gives you the only two ones you can get.
Right.
And it shows you what they are. So...
We didn't actually put the modem in.
Yeah. Anyway.
Anyway, back to the story.
Back to the story.
So far, she's on the ground giggling her little balls off, and it is now Dire Wolf 4's chance.
Direwolf.
Which is
four.
Which one?
The one to your right.
One.
Ah.
Let's name him Pedro.
Pedro, you gonna bite
Pedro,
your dick off, man?
So in the way of does it? Is it that's? Oh fuck! Is it that's number four? That's number
yes.
three. That's number two. That's number one.
No, it starts.
Imagine it as in the letter
here.
N. It goes in the letter N.
4, 3, 2.
Blast
off!
Why would you do? Yeah, 4, 3, 2, 1. I was gonna say why are you doing it backwards. I'm like, oh wait, he's actually counting backwards. I'm an idiot.
So let's say the dire wolf.
You got yourself a Pikachu in Pokemon Go. Nice one, Emily. I'm not doing
right
too bad. I'm pretty damn happy. I have
here
a girlfriend.
Turns and snaps.
Oh no!
It's fed up with Grey Mix music.
I'm gonna bite your dick off, Issy! Huh? Pendejo? I'm gonna rip off your pendejo!
I think I'm gonna hit you with a...
The entire time my character's just going...
Oh, no,
and the wolves have had enough of it.
Even worse, you're sitting there like, boots and cats and boots and cats and boots and cats. And like, but the wolves have just been like, cats, where?
No, the wolf doesn't hit you.
It doesn't hit him?
No.
Oh, because of the... I was gonna say, why? It's just like, oh, wait, no, it failed the roll. Durr.
I don't think
wait,
a 5
I don't see
would
the
hit
roll.
Him, so.
No, a 5 wouldn't even hit me, which is yeah saying something considering I'm wearing a leather
hey,
P-bar jacket.
Right, speaking of boots and pants.
Yes.
There's a video I recognize that from.
I heard a ting, but the only thing I can see is me and... Oh, wait, never mind, there we go. Okay, well, I will watch that latier because I've got that in a private one.
Oh, that's why I didn't hear a ting.
Right, so
Jesus, I can hear the rain outside my window with my headset on.
So
Direwolf 4 has missed.
That mm-hmm was his move, so... Senpai!
Wait fucking Jesus!
It's your, it's my turn.
Okay, I shall move one square.
Now, remember, Chris, I know we have to hit her, but if she does get hit, she has a chance to stop finding it funny that you're kicking
her in
the teeth.
Do you guys hear this rain?
Jesus, as soon as you did that, yeah.
Well, either way.
You're pissing into a bucket.
When I'm not talking, but as soon as I start talking, you can hear the rain pelting down at my window.
That's ridiculous.
Fucking Jesus, there is... Jesus, I can't see anywhere that doesn't have a stream. The flat road has a river going down it at this point.
Man, the lifeboats!
Quick, get the kayak!
Quick,
Chris,
you know all the KFC buckets we have? Get the duct tape, I've got an idea. Bastard sword! 4 slashing with a critical fail. A crit. Well, the thing is, it's a crit fail with a +3, so I don't know, does that count as a crit fail? I don't know. I don't think it does. I don't know. Oh my god, he actually called it Notice Me Senpai.
No, Miss Pierce called it Notice Me Senpai. I just never changed it.
Lol.
He just obliges.
So, you hit her for 4 damage, and she now has to make her wisdom throw as well to see if she stops finding it funny.
Okay, let's just grab my lucky dice.
The thing is, though, because I go first every time, I could just do it every time for the next, like, 2 rounds to stop her from doing anything. I have no attacks left, but... Is that higher than her wisdom? Or intelligence? Was it? Yeah?
Oh,
wisdom save... Not... Yeah, wisdom. If it's higher than her wisdom, then yes.
No.
Damn. That's... Oh, wait, no, damn. It's good. That means that she's still laughing.
Good. I slashed the bed, she didn't find the
For some reason, I can only see the rolls for characters.
Beautiful. She's legitimately lamowing.
Murky.
No, sorry, roughly.
Yeah.
It's thy blind turn.
Quick, punch it to oblivion.
Yeah. Run up there and Falcon punch her.
Falcon punch! And turns just like a blood... Just turns into blood mist. Fuck.
The wolf tried to bait me, narrowly dodge it, and then you just punch fuck out of it.
God!
Which one?
No, like, you just
Both
swing round,
the nearest
you punch
one to
it so hard
he's just
the skeleton
hit it.
Comes out its body, but the body's still intact.
He's just hit it for 41. He got the 15 on the first, he critted the second with the 15, so the additional damage goes on top, so he hits it for 41.
He punches it so hard that the skeleton comes out of its body
That's
intact.
That's gonna use a key point.
And then he punches the body again until there's nothing
basically
left.
Basically, you had a crit, so that means that you can explain what you're doing.
Oh. I basically punched it and it just, like, just blood. Just everywhere.
It just exploded.
You punch it so hard that
it turns
just,
from matter into just blood. Just
it's just
everywhere.
Blood
the
mist.
Wolf's
just
body disappears and is replaced with a red cloud.
It's not raining.
Give me a second, guys. I'm gonna get
May the red mist start. Boom. Okay, this is weird. I can't buy this for you. It's saying I gotta send it to my address, not yours. I don't know how Amazon wish lists work.
More or less, I just red misted it.
Did I fuck something up?
Are you going to use an attacking move?
I don't know, McWonderlama. I don't know anything.
Ricky.
What? It's not my go.
I know, but I'm asking, do you think you're going to use an attacking move? Because it might buff you.
Oh god, yeah. No, the way it works is, I'll do that first so it can't incapacitate us first. Because I'm going to get the shot first, I want to do damage, considering I've only got 2 more spell slots in level 1 to use. I had to use mage armor to get myself an extra 3 AC. And one to make her continuously laugh or get slapped in the face with a sword. So I've got 2 level 2s and 2 level 1s left. And I really don't want to have to spend another level 1.
I'm just
going to
make the Bardic Inspiration thing into a cantrip. Because it's like one of my class things, but I don't have a role for it. So.
Unless it says in the book that it's a cantrip, or if it has to stay as a level whatever it is. Unless it is a cantrip.
No, it's just one of my basic class things.
Oh,
it's a
right.
Class
can you use it whenever?
Yeah.
Oh, that reminds me. I can use Hellish Rebuke once a day. Thank you.
It's just that I don't have an actual role for it. So
I do not have a P.O. box, McWonderlama. I looked into that. It's like £200 a year. No. No chance. If Murky can help me figure out why it's broken. Yeah.
It's your turn, so what are you going to do?
One moment.
The cha-cha?
The cha-cha slide?
Slide to the left!
to the right. Square dancing, because if you're going to do that, I'm all in.
Where to come from? Where to go? Where to come from? What now, Joe?
That's not square.
Okay, I know, but it's the only song I can think of. Bardic Inspiration on Brick.
God, yes, I love it when he plays through the fire and flames.
Oh, wait, I didn't show the description.
He pulls out a lute and starts playing through the fire and flames.
Bitch is going to get set on fire and she's going
to
fucking hit.
That's literally what I do to inspire him.
Select a creature within 60 feet and give them a 1d6 Bardic Inspiration die. Can be used a 1 ability check, attack rolls, or saving throws once used its last. So I can roll a 1d6 on top of whatever my attack.
You can roll an extra d6 on an attack or damage roll.
Okay. Well, I will use that when it gets to my turn.
So I get to do that, and what else do I get to do on my turn?
That's
a bonus action. Exactly. If you don't move, you get to do an attack if you've got a ranged attack.
Yeah, you can't move.
Can I just do one from standing here?
If you have a ranged attack, yes. So like, if you could like play you could play the brown note and all the wolves will shit themselves to death.
Nope, that's not gonna happen.
He pulls out an oboe from his backpack. Where did you get that?
Of madness on one of the wolves next to the banshee.
How far is the range?
It doesn't have range.
Well then,
it's basically something he can see.
It's basically just a line of sight. If I can see it, I can cast it.
Well, then if you can see it, then yeah. Because this is like a pathway.
Because the one in front of me is dead, so I can just do it on that one.
Yes.
Yes.
Wait, on the one in front of you? Like this one?
Yeah, that one's dead.
No,
that one's dead and gone.
Mist cloud. So.
Yeah, you can do it on this one. Because you're looking through the mist.
Concentration up to 1 minute, so you have to concentrate that one spell.
Well,
do I get to make an attack this turn?
Wait, no, Greymek, you can't.
Why?
It's not humanoid. It's a wolf. It's animal. Humanoid of your choice. Now, the banshee is humanoid.
The rest aren't.
You could cast it on the banshee, as it is a humanoid character. It's a ghost, but it is still a humanoid. I think. I'm pretty sure.
I'll do it on that then.
Now he has to make 2 wisdom saving throws.
It's an undead.
But the thing is, it's an undead, but it's still a humanoid.
Yeah, it's like elves. Elves are elvish, but it's like, but they're still humanoid. They have the 2 legs, 2 arms, you know, they look like humans. Banshees are ghosty things, but they look like humans.
A humanoid.
Yeah. Because it's part human.
What are you doing?
Slipping in the finger round the back door. The number one hit single from Brick Slayer. I screamed out stop, but I wanted more.
A collaboration between Brick Slayer and DJ Ray off.
Why am I not banned yet? Oh my god.
Brick Slayer and Rapey Sloth's new album. She wanted more.
Oh god.
Brick, I don't know what to do.
You're telling me. I'm
knocking on the back door.
Shall I let him in?
What?
He's fucking out the back door! Do you wait a minute?
Oh my god! Aha! Oh cool, McWonder Llama got it! Nice! Somehow I've broken my PC. Right now I'm looking at a purple screen and it's making a loud beep noise. Oh shit. Murky?
Then how are you messaging?
Have you ever heard of that before? Purple screen and making a loud beep noise. This is the munging all over again. except that Murky doesn't have to be drunk to enjoy it. Not the munging!
Hang on. What operating system does your computer run? Because I...
It's Emily. You remember Emily, don't you?
Yeah, but why never? What operating system is she running? Because, like, a purple. Is there white text on this purple screen?
You might want to jump into the Twitch chat and
hearsay.
I just need to know because
it'd be like the 24-second delay.
Wait, I did my class action, like, my class feature, and then I cast a spell. Do I get to move, or is that it?
No, you don't get to move, that's it. You've done your bonus action and your action.
I need to do a wisdom saving throw for that, actually.
Well, the target's charmed and the twisted crown is your gun appears ahead.
The only thing I can think of where you get a purple screen and beeping is on a virtual machine.
I can't.
It's to do with kernel. It's to do with kernel host system
I'm
stuff.
Prepared.
It's it's weird. I don't know. I don't understand a purple screen.
Put it up your ass, please.
With a beeping noise.
Brick Slayer's second hit his sickle. Do you know what? That's the backing singing going on whilst me and Reapy Sloth are doing that. Emily said...
That was nice.
Once again, her face said no, but her head said I wanted it more. Emily says no, just plain purple.
Okay, so what operating system?
What operating system is it, Emily?
In the meantime, I'm feeding my fish, but okay.
But yeah, Brick, or choose an Amazon pickup location. Amazon pickup location is likely to collect your parcels at the time and place that's convenient for you exclusively at Pass My Parcel locations. You can take advantage of evening pickup and express. I don't even know if there's an Amazon pickup location near me.
There is. It's Argos. Well, or
really?
I think that's eBay. eBay does for Argos. You might need to ask them.
Well, I can just
check.
Just go on to
or just Google if there's a.
We just use Amazon. It'll have a thing somewhere. I'm sure.
Anyway, I need the operating system it's using because otherwise I won't have a fucking clue. Because if it's Windows 8 or Windows 10, then you just need to restart the computer. Because what that is that means that the default, like the Windows process for the file browser has and the desktop has just crashed, which means you need to reset the computer or reboot it even.
So turn your PC off and on again, Emily.
Well, like,
that still hasn't made any difference.
If
then,
it's
so
Windows
be a
8, if it's Windows 8 or Windows 10, that's what you need to do. If it's not any of those, I don't know what the fuck you've done. Because that's technical source.
Hello, welcome to tech support. This is Roy. Have you tried turning it off and back on again?
Obviously, that's the first thing. It's turn it off and on again. If that doesn't fix it, then you've done something. But if it's Windows 8, 8.1 or 10, then it's just a process.
Dilo says, pretty sure Amazon is Argos as well. Post office. There's two post offices near me, one on either side at a shop, or there's the big one in Lisburn. Search by postcode.
So, it was... right, I'm going to have to fucking... Because if they're not going to say what the operating system is, I will have no fucking clue.
I can...
7, 8, or 10.
Oh, there's actually quite a few.
Like 8.1 or 10. That's what I need to know.
So, Piercy, did it pass the saving throw?
No.
I have taken control of the Banshee.
That's all I need to know. If it's 8.1 or 10, if it's any of those, I can help you fix it. If it's not, then if you don't tell me, I can't help.
Do you know what? You can send it to one of those two top locations because there are actually both of the post office, like I said, both sides actually do it. That's pretty cool. Is handy to know. See? Is handy to know. Or the post office. Right.
So right now it's dialogue number 3's turn.
Which is... This
is one? Yes.
Yes,
So the Banshee is now under Greymet's control whilst it still continues to laugh its tits off.
Is Emily even in chat still?
On my screen on the... Oh, yep. Yeah. She doesn't have Windows 8 or 10. So is it 7 then?
Concentration up to 1 minute. Did we just go back and tell my turn again and then it's over?
Because... No, that means that you... The next turn, I don't think that means you can do any other attacks that require you to concentrate. As you're sitting there being like, you know, concentrate, concentrate. So, for example, say I was doing like a concentration spell and then I was just like, you know, concentrate. I can do an instant one, so I can literally concentrate, concentrate, fireball, concentrate, cut that. I think that's kind of what you can do. I'm not sure, though. Possibly. But it has to make...
Yeah, but what about the time limit?
1 minute is
up to one
round.
Minute. Each round is like 6 seconds, was it not? Or is that each turn?
So
it's turn, I believe.
So yeah, I was right. It's up until it's my turn again.
Yeah. But as we continue, if I may.
Yes, continue, please.
So, Chris.
Yes, darling.
You have a direwolf next to you.
Hello.
He's gonna bite your balls off.
Well, the last one tried.
Going to try and
bite
your ankles with an 20.
What?
Oh, it rolled a 20. Oh wait, no, hold on, Chris. You got like 24 AC, don't you?
No, my AC's 20.
That means that 20 were above. That means it hits. Ooh, if it has to hit you, it has to crit it. Greedy's like, shh, I'm not here. Fucker.
It hits?
Greedy, you scum!
Okay,
a 20 will hit him.
It will hit him. Okay. And you take...
And then Greedy goes, no.
Ooh, not good. 15.
I take 15 damage.
Yes.
Jesus, he must have ripped your Achilles heel as well as nibbling at your ankles. Like, what's this?
Right. Tore your Achilles tendon in half.
32 minus 15.
17.
Is 17.
You're not going to be able to walk for a while.
Hard edge change. Sorry, no, this I found is...
it. You can do it on your. You can either do it on your main it's character so or do it on your character sheet. It doesn't matter which one, but it just makes life easier. Wow, you took a lot of damage.
Yeah.
Are you sure that's right?
Yep.
But he said he had 32.
No, 32. So 17. 17. Sorry, I need to bring it up two more. Sorry.
Yeah, that's what I was looking at. It's just like that's less than half. I'm pretty sure you didn't take 17, so that wouldn't. Have, yeah, there you go. So that means that Grey, you're probably gonna have to throw him a heal if he's standing right in front of the banshee and two direwolves.
I can't help Emily if she's not gonna tell me what the operating system is, let alone what the actual computer itself is.
Don't worry, I'll heal him. But
if it's a laptop, next... it just means
I'm gonna lose control of the banshee on my turn anyway. So,
well, not if you just keep concentrating.
Well,
because it's up to a minute.
Shit.
So once it gets back around to me, I lose control.
Right.
So basically, it's not going to get to make its turn. I make.
Oh, it does because it gets its turn. It's the one after this direwolf. So you control it in the next turn.
So do I get to control it on its turn?
Yes.
Yeah, but there's only one problem.
It's still
giggling. Yeah, it's still sitting there giggling.
It needs to succeed a saving throw on Brick's thing, and then it can actually do something. If not, then
every time it's. It's turn, or it gets attacked. It has to make a wisdom saving throw on my one.
So it has to do two saving throws. It has to do a saving throw on Brick's thing and your thing, and then you can do it.
Yeah.
It's meant to be at the end of it, but it's under two effects, so you do them at the beginning.
Yeah.
Because if it did it at the end, it could do some serious shit and then be free.
Yeah.
And do its own stuff. Because someone's has got effects at the end, so just... It needs to roll wisdom saving throw for being controlled, as well as the giggling fit.
I still can't believe that if that's a thing and it worked.
Yeah. It's not really meant to be used on monsters, that's the thing. It's meant or any kind of humanoid monster. It's meant to be used on people. But, like, you know.
Oh, shit, does it. A creature of your choice that you
yeah,
can
see. Yeah, a creature of your choice, but, like,
it's okay.
Regularly.
As soon as I saw that, I was just sort of like, oh shit, did I put it on something I can't? It's like, no, it's okay, creature. That's alright.
Hey, like, as long as Emily doesn't tell me what the operating system
here's
is.
Here's the thing, Brick.
Laptop,
he doesn't know that you're not a creature because he doesn't know what you look like.
I like how as well she said, I need to stop the beep noise. It's like, I can help you fix the beep noise. Tell me what the fucking thing is. And
Emily.
She just doesn't tell me anything.
We need
again,
the OS.
Emily, I can fix it for you right now. If you tell me what the computer is and what the operating system is, if you can tell me, I can help you immediately. If you don't tell me, I can't help you. And at this point, I'm just not going to because
you don't tell them. Oh fucking well, you're screwed.
Like, you can try and Google it if you want because I'm pretty sure I know what it is. I don't even need to Google it to know what it is.
Right. So Direwolf 1 has already just eaten part of. No, sorry.
Direwolf
3. Direwolf 3's kind of take a little bit of Chris's ankles with him.
Yep.
Yeah.
Chris is now missing half his leg.
Yeah.
Now this one is it's his turn. And he decides to focus on you, Rick.
Now, question. Because he runs to me but past Murky, is that attack of opportunity for Murky? Because it is adjacent.
He didn't pass Murky.
He's out to the side, though.
No. If that was the case, it would have to go... Well, first of all, my line of sight is this.
Oh, you're standing sideways. Okay, never mind.
Line of sight. And it would,
my bad.
First of all, if I was there and it went across to you like that, yeah, I'd get attacking opportunity on it. But because it just went, like, it completely avoided it.
Okay, my bad. I wasn't looking at where your position was. I'm gonna regret not killing one of these wolves, am I?
What are you talking about, Murky? You don't have a line of sight. You're blind.
Well, no, exactly. even being blind, you still have, like, a cone of sense.
I think you're lucky, Brick.
If we were gonna cheat and said I had an area as opposed to a cone, that would be more broken.
I am. Even if I didn't have a mage armor, that would be one under what you'd need to hit me. I've got 14 for this fight, because I put mage armor on. It would normally be 11, so it doesn't hit.
I mean, like,
you're lucky. You're lucky.
My nads are saved for one more turn.
I brought food.
Nice. Okay, so it is the Banshee's turn. You have to roll two wisdom saving throws for my one first, because I was the first one put it on, then...
Because technically, for being blind, instead of line of sight, it would be that. That's what it would be.
Okay.
In terms of people crossing, but I'm not going to do it like that. Yeah, like an area of...
So the first one is equal?
If it...
It's equal.
It has to roll your AC or above to hit.
I thought
essentially.
Wisdom saving throws are becoming... The end of his turn, the target if it is triggered by... Oh, okay. On a success, the spell ends...
If that thing succeeds a wisdom saving throw,
must succeed
ends.
A wisdom saving throw. So that means that if it's on the number above.
Okay. So what you have is I made you write down a thing that told you what your wisdom saving throw was, or what you had to do for a wisdom saving throw.
It's not like
or
really
like save DC or something.
Yeah.
It should be in class line. That is.
Class. It's all about evocation stuff. Class. I don't think it's in class.
Wait, so does it have to do another wisdom saving throw for me?
Yes.
Yeah, it has to do a wisdom saving throw for you and for me.
That's confusing because it did one on the turn that I cast spell.
No, okay. When you do a wisdom when you do something on someone and it fails wisdom saving throw, that's when you cast it, but it also has to do it on its turn so that you maintain control of it.
I take it Colin Miller's a type of furniture.
Because just doing it so that, like, you control it and then, like, it gets around to your turn, then you fail, that basically means you've cancelled out something's turn. That would be unfair if I did it to you, let alone to it. So the way it works is that you roll it, it rolls it on its turn.
Thank you very much, Adam, for the host. I appreciate you because we are lover Brick.
With some
how
very,
you doing, dude?
Very rare exceptions of spells. Like with a Beholder. Thing. Where a Beholder has like six effects it can put on people at like any one time, but it has to roll for all of them on the same turn.
What were you going to say, Percy?
She's going to go get something.
What?
She went to go get something to eat.
Okay.
He says as he puts something in his mouth to eat. Right, so the Banshee has just broken free of the giggle fits.
Hopefully it fails its wisdom saving throw for me.
That means once it gets up It then has to make a wisdom save. Well, before it gets up, it has to make a wisdom saving throw to see if it's still under your control. If it is, you have to get it up off the floor, which is that an action because it has to stand up? Or is that what? A bonus action?
What?
Well, because the Banshee is on the floor laughing because of my spell, and Greymek took it over, because it passed mine, it means it no longer is giggling away, but it's still on the floor. Because Greymek's got control of it, does that mean he has to use one of its actions to stand
it
up?
It has to do another
attack?
Saving throw to see if I still have control.
Well, that's what I'm saying. If you are still in control, do you have to get it up off the ground, which is the bonus action of technically moving, or does it just get up is fine? Like, is it considered an action standing up?
It's actually moving.
Right, so that would be a movement, so all you could do is attack. Which means you'd have to attack one of the wolves beside you if you've got something ranged. But, Piercy, you need to do another wisdom saving throw to see if the Banshee is still underneath Greymek's effects.
Yes, it is.
There you go, Greymek. Okay, so, what can Greymek do?
What can I do with it?
When you have it under the control of Crown of Madness... Christ. Basically... You control it, but it can only make melee attacks.
Oh.
Okay. Is that it?
Now, yeah, that's about it. And since you control the Banshee, which is very piss poor in melee combat...
It has only one...
It has one in strength. Shadow. It's got one in strength, which I think is like a minus, like...
Couldn't four. I just make it scream?
Minus
no,
five.
No, because when you control it, you can only make it do melee attacks.
Alright.
You can make it act normally, but you can't actually, like, it even says in your description for Crown of Madness, and I know because I had to read this for Crown of Madness, you can't make it do any special capabilities. That's why what you would do is that you, like, I was very skeptical of you using it at the start. That's why I said you probably shouldn't use it, because
I didn't Crown hear of Madness, you.
Yeah, again, you haven't heard me many times when I tried to explain stuff to you, it seems, but basically Crown of Madness is more sort of a counter to a very sort of big, lumbering... like enemy that you'd encounter, sometimes like an ogre or something that's in a way a humanoidish creature.
Well, on the
in all honesty,
side,
it's just so
used...
that it can't attack anyone and it can't scream.
Well, I'd say
even at that,
I mean, use it on the wolf.
You could have put it to sleep, for example. Like you could have done many things.
Well, I mean, now you can use it to attack the wolf, and
well,
then
you
it
can,
would deal with
those
things.
Like it's got like a minus four to everything it's gonna do.
What?
So it's, it,
well, yeah,
it,
but still,
it's
a minus five.
Yeah, it's got one strength. And when you have stats, you have a modifier to it.
Oh, it's
got
a minus four.
It's
that
like
means
minus
you're gonna
five.
You're gonna give it
means,
health when you punch it.
It
becomes
no, it
a melee
very,
healer.
It means not only are you very unlikely to hit it, you're very unlikely to do any damage if you do hit it.
Yeah.
And it would have been more effective to just put it to sleep. Because you could have
It's a learning experience. D&D is a learning thing.
Crown of Madness, fine. Like, you've done it. You might as well attack something.
I'm gonna attack this one to get it off of Chris.
Right.
Okay, Nimble. You want me to roll for it?
Welcome back, Wonder Lemma.
Sure.
Okay. Only 20 plus true is a 15.
Cookies.
14. It hits.
Okay.
Now, what I want you to do is... for me...
Hello, Gregor's man. How are you doing, dude? Welcome in.
Is roll 3d6 plus 2.
Jesus, 3d6 plus 2?
Yeah.
Is that for a melee attack?
That's a melee attack.
Dear,
on the Banshee.
Dear God. Mm-hmm. Even with a minus 5, that's still 9.
No.
14 minus 5 is 9.
Actually, no, you did just roll it, right? So minus 5, that's 9.
See, the best thing is Murky's just said no and the number 9, and he's not confused because he's German. That's a no. What? No, that's 9. That's what I said, that's a no.
No. No, damn it.
So he does 9. That's still quite a high amount with a plus 2 on it on top.
What did he roll to attack? To attack as opposed to doing damage.
I just did what Piercy told me.
Which was
3d6 plus 2.
Yeah, Pierce, was that to make an attack, or was that to do damage?
That was the damage, because she rolled and it did hit.
She rolled it so that it would actually hit the thing. Then she said, you need to roll this, so it's public, and it means that, you know, everyone can, like, sort of figure it out. You've never played D&D? McWonderland, but there's a lot of people out there who haven't, because they're all like, oh, I'm going to hit you with my plus one sword. Oh, no, meh, no, no. It's all full of nerds. Like, it's not. As you can see, we have a lot of fun with it.
Yes, it's not that action, because that's an actual spell.
Okay.
That's not the actual melee. A melee would be you roll a d20 and you take 5 away from it to do the, to actually attack. That's what that is.
Ah.
Like, because it basically means, like, you, when it says you do action to do a melee attack, it's like a default melee attack, because the melee attack spell is different.
Okay.
That's still a casting action, yeah?
Who's the DM?
Pierce is, and I'm telling her, because she's using the monster manual, which I have up as well to see what the Banshee does. And I'm just making sure that she's reading it correctly.
Yeah,
because
the one
she was reading was in the actions. It has a few actions. One of them is Corrupting Touch, which is a melee spell attack. Which is it's a melee spell. And when you're controlling a monster, any kind of monster, through Crown of Madness, you can't make it use spells. It only does default melee. And default melee is you would roll a d20. This is how attack rolls are done anyway. It's a d20 plus its modifier. So if you
just tell me what to do already.
Yep. So if it rolls a 15, then you take the 5 off of it, I guess. That makes it 10.
No,
so,
I rolled a 20.
Oh, you rolled
it. It was a 15.
You critted the roll.
I critted the roll. All
right. Well, that'd be nice to see. So it rolls 15. So yeah.
So what do we do for damage?
9.
Damage.
Oh, well. Then they roll another 20.
On a basic melee attack. Let's see. Does it have it in here? What do I have for a basic melee attack? I'm trying to remember what the basic melee attack roll would be. I guess you can choose. Like, it would have to make sense for a creature that doesn't really specialize in melee.
But I didn't, like, roll
anything.
A d4?
Well, that means that.
Well,
means
I mean,
it's mind finest
type. I'd say, like, I don't know. Like, but again, Banshee isn't really a melee damaging class. It has the ability to grapple, technically, but like that's like as far as I would say it would go. Like, because it's one of those weird ones where it's in a situation where he's controlled a character that isn't a melee character in any way, shape, or form, but has capabilities to do melee if it could do spells.
Yeah, but you can't do spells.
But he
can't
do it because of what he's done to control it, so it's essentially completely useless.
Well, on the plus side, that does mean that for 2 turns solid, it hasn't been able to actually attack anyone with a possibility of more.
But what he could have done was he could have put it to sleep.
It doesn't matter. It's in the past now. Get over it.
All right, calm down.
I just want to know what I have to roll, okay?
Well, if you have to roll a 5, it's literally, or like, you'd have to roll a 5 or more, but if you're rolling a d4, it's going to be 0 no matter what.
So just, I guess whatever Pierce would like you to roll for, like, damage, I guess you're going to roll it.
Peter C.
I'd say a d12.
Roll
d12.
A
d12. Roll a d12.
2.
Right,
okay.
So yeah.
Wow.
Whoops. Yeah. I was going to say, hold on, how did he crit a 2 on a 12? Okay, you do 3 damage. Not bad. Still something. Good. You do 3 damage to the direwolf beside Urgleth.
Better than nothing.
Mm.
Mm-hmm.
And still under your control. No, is it?
Until my turn.
Oh yeah, until your
turn.
So he's still got... It's still a good wee time to get some more boots in. It's fine. Dire Wolf number 2 on the left hand side of Argoth.
On the left hand side of Argoth is going to take a little
nibble at me again.
He's gonna take another nibble.
Yeah, he's a little hungry, I'm sorry.
Oh god, if it bites your other ankle, you're gonna be paralyzed and almost dead.
The Dire Wolves are run by you. I know you're hungry. Jesus Christ, come on.
Could be worse. Could bite your dick.
Actually, this one is going for
the dick.
Let's say the right testicle.
Oh no! Not. Why is it always the left one?
She said, well,
they're showing the love this time.
It's I don't think he bites through the armor.
You're lucky, because the last time it had something to do with the testicles, she shot Grease clean off.
That was a critical fail, actually.
Yeah, that was a critical fail, as a gnome standing between someone's legs slipped and shot up, and it was just... So, Wolf fails. You still have both testicles intact.
Thank God.
It's good, it's good. My turn! I think, to save some spell slots, I'm going to use a cantrip.
Just beat the shit out of the thing in front of you.
yes.
Cast Summon Witch Fireball and use the extra d6 I gave you.
Literally what I was about to do, to be honest, because it's like, well, it's right there. It doesn't miss. It just has to have, like, damage. So, first of all, we do this. Boom! He crits it, and then... We do
just
this.
Roll a d6.
Oh, double crit! I never get lucky.
It's as if you
that.
Just shot it in a furnace, locked the door, and put it on high.
So I double critted.
It squeals.
I'm not surprised.
It doesn't have time to squeal. It's just been evaporated.
Well,
not
no.
Why.
They've got a bit more health than
burning,
that.
It's burning. That's for sure.
It's definitely burning, but. I don't actually...
its body's missing at this point.
Deadpool looks better than this wolf right now.
It's as if you just shot an entire wall of flame and just all the flesh on half of its body is gone and just skeleton is left.
Now it's Diol's fourth turn. He's just basically playing death.
Wait, isn't one of the Diol's dead?
Yeah.
Yes.
So you can remove him from the turn order, I guess.
Oh.
The
D4
one, yeah.
Death.
So the one in front of me took a
roll
solid
a
D100 16.
To see if it comes back to life.
Oh god, don't even. Don't even.
To see if the cloud of mist reforms. Turns out it was a vampire wolf.
No.
Oh god. It didn't die, it just managed to disappear before you actually hit it. Like, oh my god, you are evil and devious, I like it. Oh,
Chris.
I got dad botted.
Yes, my love.
Stab
something.
Deadfoot,
yeah!
Right, I've got three options here. Before, I could always run away.
No, you have no option to run away. That means that all three... No, actually, the two wolves would have an attack of opportunity on both of you, because the Banshee is under control of Greymex, so it wouldn't. Running away would be a really, really bad idea.
Basically, your best bet is already hitting the one that's taking damage.
Yeah.
Which I assume was this one, out of all of them.
No, he didn't hit that wolf. He hit.
Which one did he hit?
He hit the Banshee.
He hit this one.
I hit the Banshee.
He hit the Banshee.
Oh, no, I'm talking about which one Greymek hit with the Banshee.
Oh, that's right. Then that. Yeah. Then that is the one on the right. Yeah.
Yeah. So the one that's already damaged.
Yeah. My bad. Sorry. Doopy doop. So yeah. Don't. You don't turn to hit it, do you? You just sort of stand there.
Well, he'd have to turn to hit it.
Would that give the one on the left?
No, because he's not moving away from it.
But it'd be given an advantage on his turn because his back's turned?
Well, that's why I'm going to get it next turn.
Ah.
Right, we're fine. I'm going to be attacking.
You touch my tra-la-la.
Yes?
Yeah,
it's ridiculously loud.
That sounds ridiculous.
I'd be careful what you're doing, Murky. Remember, as soon as you walk forward?
Oh, I know.
I got ergasmed. Okay.
It's funny because it's as if I have plans for this.
Yeah, 15. Does a 15 hit the wolf?
15 hits the wolf.
15 hits the wolf with 13, and that's a critical hit, too. Critical 10 with a +3 on his sword, so. Nice. That's three crits in a row there. My 2 plus his 1. We're on a roll, guys.
Roll again.
Not the honor roll. Honor roll.
And my wolf is squealing.
Sorry, no, that's the angry rabbit, sorry. I said angry rabbit. You filthy minded
people. I just found
out
something quite disturbing.
What's that?
I can heal Chris.
But?
But to do so, I need to put him to sleep.
You're not doing
what?
That.
No.
Right. So we, in fact, then have no healer to stop. Oh, God.
It's fine.
And
lie.
If I was to do so, it may also heal the wolves.
Yeah, don't do it. Don't do it then.
Oh, God. Wait, no, hold on. If it was you healing something, would it not only heal friendly allies instead of the things around you?
No, because it's probably an area of effect heal.
It's an area of effect. Look, this is the spell. Read the description.
Yeah, sends creatures into magical slumber. Roll 5d8. So as many potent creature. This spell can affect creatures within 20 feet of the point you choose.
I don't think Cure Wounds does that.
Starting.
Well,
yeah,
that's the description that
I'm pretty sure
I got from the website.
Starting with a creature that has the lowest current hit points, each creature affected by the spell falls unconscious until the spell ends. The sleeper takes damage.
You've combined the descriptions of the spell sleep and the spell cure wounds. Because I know that sleep only
I'm pretty sure cure wounds only does
you've
like
1d4. Two spell descriptions.
I'm pretty sure.
Because I know for a fact that the spell sleep is 5d8. You've combined two spell descriptions. Cure Wounds doesn't do that. Cure Wounds is a contact spell that you have to be like in touching range of the target to do it on. Because I had to tell Brick how to set his up on his last character.
Cure Wounds.
On your medic one, on your healing one, I had to tell him, and I had a paladin as well, so I had Cure Wounds. And Cure Wounds is a contact spell.
That's what happened. Cure Wounds is right below sleep, so I put it into the wrong one.
Yeah.
A creature you touch regains a number of hit points equal to 1d8 plus your spell casting ability modifier. This spell has no effect on the undead or constructs.
Yeah, so, yeah. He did just combine two spell descriptions.
My bad,
oh, Brick,
sorry.
I see you're going on a comeback tour. What? Comeback tour?
Tour?
Who?
I don't know. What do you mean, Wonder Llama?
Don't know what he's talking about.
I don't know what he's talking about.
Anyway, right, start. Wait.
So, you need to take this Scrimmick.
Oh, God.
And change the reins to touch. Limp Biscuit. I look like Fred Durst. I'm not sure if I'm supposed to take that as a compliment or insult. Is it the bandana? Is that what it is?
I think that's
how
it.
Do I change it so that when I cast the spell, it rolls the d8 for me?
Click the box that says healing and change the bottom box to 1d8. So if I go to mine...
You need to click the red thing that says healing and tick the box that says
so
healing.
Be a little one that says healing here, one there, and then the heal amount is where you change it to right. 1d8 like that. But I'm not going to do that because I've just fucked up mage armor, which would heal me by 1d8, which makes no sense.
Right. Yeah, I've just done that. So that's there if you want to look. The box I take everything I click.
So that means that you would have to run up and touch him. But that means one of two problems.
So I put 1d8 and heal amount.
Yes. Now, right, yeah. The issue is, yes, you could reach him. Yes, you could do it. But then you will have two wolves in front of you. And you don't attack unless something attacks you. And you've got a tiny little dagger that does fuck all.
The issue he's also standing with is that he's got to use an action on his turn to roll the thing
for
the Banshee.
Wait, what? No, the Banshee because has to roll the saving throw. He doesn't
No.
No, I lose control of the Banshee this turn.
No.
One, up to 1 minute.
On turns, you must use your action to maintain control over the target or the spell ends.
Piercy said that it was only, each round
is a
minute. It
was up to a minute, which was one round.
That's what Piercy said.
Oh, it was around? All right, fine.
But actually, no, because since that other wolf died, it'll be the turn after that I lose control. Because it didn't make a turn.
Right, regardless, just hurry up and worry about shit later.
We've pressed the turn right now.
I'm still waiting.
So, you can either attack one of the wolves of range, because I would not suggest running up there.
What,
it's Chris's turn!
What did Gray do?
Now
Gray
the turn
was doing it, it's not his turn. It's my turn.
Yeah.
Oh, right, okay.
We were trying to fix his spell, and then you were trying to tell him what you should do. It's like, it's not his turn. Right, I'm going to spend 2 key points out before I have to get disengage, so I don't get attacked by that fucker, that wolf there. Right. And then I can freely go to this fucker.
Bringeth the red mist!
Fucking get shit on wolf.
Oh.
Yeah, emo bastard.
12 and 8 is a 20.
It's still something. It's pretty good.
And I'm going to draw his aggro from it. Because that's second key point. Fuck my life, right. Well, 20 and he should be mad at me and not Chris. Okay. Well, let's target to attack Chris. I did spell proficiency wrong somehow.
Next one.
Greymek! The bird! So, now, if you do run up, Murky has got the aggro of the wolf on the left. The wolf on the right has the aggro on Chris. But if you run up to it, I think you could run up and heal him. That's it. But if that thing decides to attack you next, that's...
I wouldn't be able to do anything else?
No, you have your action.
If you run
movement.
Straight up to Chris here, you're in its sight. That's why I just say, run to here, you're out of its sight still, and you can heal him, or you get attacking advantage and just straight up kill it.
Have you taken the aggro of this one?
Yeah, that's what I've just done.
Yeah, he's just
walked up, hit it twice.
Couldn't I just kill it from here?
You could.
Do you have... Okay, well, what one would you be attacking?
That one.
Right, do you have an attack that could kill it at that range?
Well, how much health does it have?
I know, but we've done overall, like, there was 16 health done, 16 19. Damage done to it. It's got 90, so can you do 19 in one hit?
No.
And there you go. It's... So then your best bet is running up to it, out of its line of sight, which spans that.
Yeah, so if I was looking at him, wait, if I was here, what advantage would I get on
you'd
attacking
have flanking
him?
Advantage, so you'd have advantage on your attack, which means that you're pretty much not going to miss and you'll catch it by surprise.
It doesn't do extra damage.
It does. If you get a crit on the second number, because you see how both numbers can be a crit or a fail. If you get a crit on either of them, it counts that crit.
Yeah,
by attacking from behind, that's like the only bonus. Plus it's not like... It's just the fact of, like,
I'm just gonna go here and heal Chris.
Okay, probably good idea, because
it's gonna know you're there then.
No, to this bit.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, it'll know.
If you heal him, that's still contact, and then you'll draw his attention. Because when you're there, if you do any action, you'll draw its attention after that action.
Well, yeah, but if I was here, it would attack me first.
Yeah, if you go there, then it can immediately just swap to you.
Yeah, so I'll go here, then heal Chris.
Yeah, but it's still gonna know you're there on the next turn.
I can't access my character for some reason.
Because you need to change the ruler to the little mouse hand thing.
Oh, yeah. I bet.
I just say, like, do you have any melee attack at all?
Because, I haven't put one in.
Because of his backstory, he will not attack something unless it attacks him first, and he only has a dagger to protect himself.
Well, I have a kukri knife.
Well, just heal Chris.
Which, to be fair, can cleave a cow's carcass in twain, but whatever.
Yeah, but I mean, the cow has to get pissed off and attack you first. Right, 1d8.
I don't know if I have, like, a thing to roll for doing melee damage, so I would just have to do that later. But for now, I am going to heal Chris. Where's my...
1d8.
I think I'm looking in the wrong section, aren't I?
Well, spellbook.
Spell is it?
Which
I'm looking for cure wounds. There
spellbook
it is.
Level 1.
Right, so you have to expend one of your spell slots for doing that, and you healed him 1 HP. Hold on. Equal to 1d8 plus your spell casting ability modifier. So what's that?
I don't think I did that.
Yeah, you wouldn't.
Okay.
So what is your... it's wisdom, or is it intellect for healing? I think it was... was it intellect for the paladins?
Wisdom for healing, intellect for damage.
Okay, so what is your wisdom?
What's your wisdom modifier?
Wait, my wisdom stat?
Wisdom modifier. Yeah, in the green box.
Wait,
next
save mod?
No. No. Like,
on core stats, you've got wisdom. What's the number?
1.
Wait,
the
what?
Total of 2.
Oh, that means that he gets healed for 2 then. So, right. Chris, yep. Add 2 to your HP.
Yeah,
best heal.
Fucking, I could have healed for more.
To be fair, you just smack some sense into him, and then he'd be like, "Oh, okay, I'm fine."
He's the hand of healing. you give one swift backhand that takes three off, gives three back, and then plus whatever you've given him as a hagel.
There we go, I've healed. I'm now up to 19, guys.
Nice.
Yay!
Okay, so Dire
but
Wolf.
But I've taken
three.
The aggro off, so at least you're not going to die immediately.
True, unless the wolf decides to.
But
that is
oh,
the
DM's
choice.
Oh, yeah, this turn I lose control of the Banshee.
Yes, so the Banshee is now back in control of itself, and all three of you are standing in front of it.
Not its turn, though.
It will be in two, though.
Yeah, so this one is...
Do you hear how devious she fucking sounds when she said that? She's got a plan.
Oh yeah, I have a plan. I've had this plan for a fucking week, okay?
Oh god, I'm so glad I'm this far back. I'm only having to deal with one wolf.
This one is going to snap.
At?
Its teeth.
It me?
Snap its
probably,
teeth.
Probably the person it's facing.
Yeah.
I imagine.
It's still
it
going
has
for
a
Chris.
Natural 20.
But I took its aggro.
No, you wouldn't take its aggro. It would still be aggro on the thing that's down to you. It would just know that you're there.
It would then, that means that the DM has a choice to attack either one.
It's what happens
if he or she so chose.
Because the
oh,
way healing
armor,
works
Chris?
Is strange.
My armor's 20.
I have a natural 20.
Oh, fuck.
So she can just bypass your armor at any point. Wonderful.
Yeah. Great.
Anyway, great. If
yeah.
you went there, it would then get the chance to just aggro straight onto you. Because you went out of its line of sight, it can't aggro to you immediately.
No so worries, McWonderlam. Thank you very much for jumping in. I appreciate it. We'll hopefully see you another day. So, a natural 20. What exactly does that mean?
Basically means that, it can just have a 20.
Oh, okay. Right. Like, at any time? Or is it like
how much I take?
Every time?
Well, natural, just a crit. It's crit, so he's
okay. Right,
he's
I get
fucked.
You. Yeah.
6+5+3 is.
Why did I have to
damage.
Fucking botch the heal?
Jesus Christ! Dire wolves are strong.
I've got
oh, yeah.
5
yeah.
HP.
They're angry little shits.
Well, you're not dead though, right?
He will
no,
only die.
Dead.
He will only die
not
when he exceeds
yet.
His maximum HP in a minus version.
Or like
when
attempt to heal him again on my next turn.
Minus, in the mine below zero and takes more damage.
No, he has to go minus 32. He has to be minus 32 to straight out die, and that's it. He is still saveable in before minus 31. We learned this one from Irish because the bastard killed me like 6 times and I kept getting back up. I was like, no, I'm not dying now. And then he sent a dragon after me, the asshole. And the dragon ate me and shat me out.
Brick?
Yes. Oh, God.
Snap,
that's.
Snap.
Oh, Christ. No. Oh, shit.
No, I won't hit you.
What did you hit? Or what did you throw?
A 5.
Oh, okay. Thank God. I get 2 crits and he fails twice. I'm doing well so far.
When the dire wolf was attacking Chris, does it not take like recoil damage from him fighting back? Or...
No.
No.
Not unless he's wearing armor or has some sort of spell.
Unless he's wearing serrated armor.
Yeah. But I don't even think that's a thing, is it?
Okay.
No, I don't think there is. Legitimately in D&D, I don't think there's fawn armor. There might be.
Okay.
So now I'm 90% sure that Chris is outright dead.
Well,
it's
not outright
it's the Banshee's turn.
Well,
we'll see what happens. The Banshee has now regained complete composure of giggling in fits on the floor and having no idea where she was.
Then again, it might
stuff.
Be really pissed at me and Brick.
Don't give her ideas.
Hang on, wait. So did the Banshee pass a wisdom saving throw for your Tasha's hideous laughter?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, right. I didn't see that bit. Okay, well.
Yeah. Well, that's because the rules are done by Piercy.
Mm-hmm.
He's using real life dice.
Oh, yeah.
So, the Banshee is completely back to its old self.
Yes.
After
want revenge.
After 3 full turns, it's now managed to get its chance to start striking.
That
back.
Or it's just gonna go over to you and be like, man, that was a fucking brilliant joke. Can I have your autograph?
Dude, you see that one about the babies and the bread? That was genius.
Okay. Yeah.
Holy shit. A 40 foot
Can
cone?
You sign my pre-order of your new, album?
Stick it in the back door. Oh god.
He's not the best.
I'm gonna have to go back and find where that was. And
who
I'm
makes a wisdom
that
saving
as an
throw?
Actual highlight. Who needs to make a wisdom saving throw?
Everyone except for Murky.
Why Murky?
The perks of being blind.
Each non-undead creature within 60 feet of the banshee that can see her must succeed on a DC 13
perks
wisdom
of being
saving
blind.
Throw.
Balls. Oh, balls.
Right, so
there's actually, found a perk to being blind.
Oh, God.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no.
Oh, God.
Oh, God, no.
I have no multiplayer thing.
Crit
the
fail.
Best of it is, if we all suddenly drop dead, Murky won't have any clue.
All you hear is, guys.
Did you kill the wall?
Is it dead?
Let's put it
I don't
way.
Think
I'm
he did.
I'm set for this enemy, I'm set for Medusa, so let's go.
Okay, let's see. Everyone who's below 13...
13 what?
So just me and Brick.
So Brick and
Wisdom.
Brick and
Oh, the wisdom saving throw?
Wisdom save, not health.
Yeah.
Oh, I was gonna say I thought it was AC, and be like, I've got mage armor, I'm not 11. Nah. And then it's just like, oh wait, no, it's the shitty 12 I threw, which was one off saving my life.
Let's see what I would have got if I'd rolled another one, shall we?
Those guys can scream like hell.
Even worse.
We can scream?
Oh yeah, you're frightened.
Okay.
It's a banshee, remember?
Sorry, that's more like laughing. It's like, ha 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 ha. It's like, no, that's sort of like terrified laughter, where you're not sure whether to scream or laugh. This is straight up just start screaming. Okay.
What happens?
So does that mean we're incapacitated? So what does that mean?
You can't attack, essentially.
Dicks.
You've got like the fear status.
Dicks.
We can't attack, but does that mean that we can't do anything?
You can't attack. You're basically stunned, essentially.
Am I good? Like, am I fine?
I wouldn't be able to heal or anything.
You're not a bitch, you're fine.
So you can't perform any actions.
It's essentially like you've just been stunned.
Shit.
For one full minute.
So one turn then.
Yeah. One round, actually.
Full round.
One rotation.
Okay, do you know what? The next one, I'm gonna make... It's like, if she fails the next one, I'm making her giggle again. Bitch.
I'm still gonna do one thing on my turn that doesn't need an action.
I dealt with number two, even.
Just because it'll be fun.
Oh, Walt number two, so he is aggro at you, actually.
Yeah, he's the angry one. Hello, Wolfie.
Yeah.
So, although that means that Murky and Chris both... are still active. Only me and Greymech are incapacitated. Great.
Yeah.
The guy who wears a paper dressing gown, that's me, and the guy who carries a kitchen knife but doesn't use it to make anything.
Dead.
That was really terrible. I was going somewhere and it just kind of like died really fucking quickly. Shit.
I rolled a 10.
That's not hitting me.
No, that's not hitting
me.
Not
in the slightest.
Brick is currently screaming like a little girl, like, ah! So that's not helpful. So I have to skip my turn.
Yes.
I can't do anything if I'm feared, so that's...
He's currently toiling, pissing, and screaming.
Yeah.
I'm shitting himself. So,
yeah. I am currently busy doing three actions, all of which are making my trousers very, very moist. And lumpy.
Like that baby bread.
Like the baby bread. Moist. Chris, on the other hand, has a chance to start hacking and slashing all around him. I'm praying he's got something up his sleeves, because if he doesn't, he's not going to have anything in his trousers after these wolves are finished with him. Come on, Chris, pull
the
something
perks
out of your...
being tall.
Come on, pull something out of your ass here. We need miracles.
I can only do either one or two things. It's either use Wrathful Smite... which more or less wastes my attack for my next attack, but I've got to die.
You'll become unconscious. You only die at minus 32 health, and at that, I think you can.
I can actually put on Lay of Shield of Faith.
Doesn't he need to do with like? death saving throws or whatever it is? Or...
When you go below zero health, if there's not somebody there to get you up immediately,
that's
who
what
can
it was.
Actually heal you, then you need to do death saving throws.
I remember there was something to do
and
with death saving
throws. If I'm stunned, he may have to do them.
Because okay. There's two ways to die. There's either you go below... Obviously, like, he has to go below 30, minus 32.
Yeah.
Like, as soon as you go below the negative equivalent of your max health, you die.
Yeah.
Or if you fail three saving throws, you basically get five chances at saving throws.
Yes.
Which is...
Well, do you remember that happened to me? And I got onto the fifth one, and I found, like, it was like, fail, live, fail, live. And I'm sitting there like, I don't want to press the button.
Right, well, what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to give Guild of Faith, which will give +2 bonus AC to one other person, either Murky or Greymek.
I would say give it to Greymek because Murky is tanky enough. Greymek needs some sort of AC up boost if one of these dire wolves turn around.
I don't know how much AC Greymek actually has.
Well, what's your AC?
I do a check.
When in your inventory, you got the armor tab. Click that. AC well, worn armor, AC unarmored.
Dude, just on your core stats page.
AC worn armor class. 12, unarmored 11.
What rules are you guys playing by? 5th edition.
Armored? What's your armored one?
12.
My rules.
12, so he has 12 AC, so you'd be better off giving it to him.
Yeah, give it to him, because then he'll have the same AC as me.
Right, okay, well, first of all, well, don't need to give you spell info. Right, okay, I am going to give... That.
You've also got your lay on hands thing you can just do for yourself. Give yourself huge health back.
Oh shit, yeah, he's a paladin!
Yeah, there's that.
Oh, yeah! So where do I go to there?
In your class? Question mark? There should be, in class feature notes, there should be lay...
Right
like,
now,
there's
only
there
one song
on
I can
hands,
think that
which is,
it just fits the situation perfectly. It's derp, derp,
it's
derp,
five
derp,
times your class
derp,
level.
Derp, derp, derp.
Five times your paladin level in hit points.
Yeah,
so
that you restore
level 4, wounds. So +20.
So you give yourself 20 hit points.
Right, okay, so I could just...
You should give yourself 20 health, basically. That's what you can do.
Fantastic.
And that's a bonus action, so...
Your action with the Shield of Faith
so he,
and bonus
he,
action.
He's used... He's not moved, so he's technically got... he's got a bonus action...
Alright, well, first of all, I'm using Lay on Hands.
Shield of Faith was a bonus action, so it wasn't an attack.
Yeah.
Shield of Faith, and then I could still attack, yeah?
You can attack, but it's nothing, no like spell attack, just like melee attack. Like,
yeah,
weapon.
Right. Then
that's
I
still
can...
fine.
Yeah, okay,
so you
right.
Can get
I wanna...
that wolf a fucking beaten.
Yeah, right, time to give the wolfie.
Time to turn his
emo
music shit
off. Punch in the face with
off.
The bastard sword.
here. The way that you like MCR.
What?
Go fuck.
Oh, a crit.
10.
It's just like, I heard you like My Chemical Romance. Get fucked! Just grabs it in twain.
You like that
it's
in twain?
It's looking really bad.
What?
You like the
it's
in twain?
Really
you said
bad.
That twice.
Yeah, the wolf looking beat the fuck up.
Well,
yeah.
I should hope so. He's been punched and slashed quite a lot.
Well, would you rather I still say, I shall cleave you in twixt?
I'll cut you in half. Don't worry, mate. I'll cut you in half, you cunt. right, so that is Chris is down, and it is now Murky.
Ooh, okay, well...
Make the red mist appear!
First thing is, 1-2.
Pa-pow! 26
on
to 26, so that is 24.
I assume at this point that's dead, at this point, because of the other damage I did to it already, which was, I've done 20 and then 24, so 44. It's dead at this point.
That's dead.
That was...
Beat.
That was just one action because the fucking monk capabilities, that was
double
fun.
Double hit.
Yep, it's basically double hit. It's like
it's
when
like
you use an attack,
you,
which
like
is
the barbarian.
Unarmed, you can attack...
they just walk
attack.
Over to me and bitch slap me. Get your act together!
That thing's been red misted as before, and I'm gonna try something on this.
I'm waiting, let's see what pops up here.
Just to see if this works. Wind do a lot.
Wind and fire wheels. Huh. Slashing and bludgeoning an 8. So does that means it's got a +7?
7-8.
Oh, okay. There was a, I was gonna say there's a minus there, but
17.
17.
17. If that hits him.
17?
Yeah, because I did... It's two attacks with that. 11 and 8.
Oh, I see it. But yeah, sorry. I missed the first one. Didn't even notice that one. I just saw the red boxes. So I was like, oh, it only does 8. Yeah. That means...
Okay.
Does 19.
Oh, 19 even.
I was going to say, where's the minus 2 come from?
Brain not working.
Brain are not to work. So that's a 19 to the Banshee.
Error 404, two not found.
Thought not found.
Intelligence less than 1.
So, yeah.
That's when your intelligence is so low that you start uninventing things.
I'm going to turn this wheel back into a stone.
Yeah.
What chair?
Chair?
It's like you go up to a statue with a hammer and chisel and just as you start hammering away,
everything comes
stone
back
starts
to it.
Reappearing over the statue.
Oh my god, you turn it back into a giant marble like stone
it's like one
rectangle.
Episode of SpongeBob where he just makes more stone by chiseling it.
Okay, that was your turn, Murky?
That is Murky's turn. Greymech, you are currently still shitting your pants from being in fear.
I grab my boombox, turn on the backing music for Bad Romance, and start going, whoa, 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 I just shit my pants.
This one is pissed.
I'm not surprised. We just killed two of its brothers.
In his pants.
Well,
I just shit in my pants.
Doesn't hit you.
Oh, which wolf did I kill and I'm now standing in the mist of?
Number two.
You don't know, you can't see.
Exactly.
That's why he's asking.
I can just feel the fact that there is mist. I'm just evaporating.
The thing is, you hit it so hard, you're like, where'd it go? Did it run away?
Oh my god, wait, no.
Guys, I know it's not raining, but why am I wet? And why does it smell like happiness?
I mean, I've got a background feature where I could technically, like, go invisible in mist. That'd be hilarious if I could do it in red mist.
Oh my god. You just punch something into, like, oblivion. The blood, like, stays up for one turn. You walk forward and disappear. Like, whoa. Oh shit, it's some sort of freaky vampire. Run.
It's freaky. OP.
Come on, miss me. Miss me. It'll be 3 in a row. Come on, miss me.
I hear.
What did you
roll?
Scared wear off again?
A 19.
Prepare to lose a leg.
Dicks!
Where's my other? There it is.
You know, being able to hide in the red, like, just disappear into the red mist of enemies you've killed would be hilarious.
13.
Technically,
is there any, like, does it stand to reason that you can?
It's like, you can attempt to hide even when you're only lightly obscured by foliage, heavy rain, falling snow, mist, and other natural phenomena.
Well, I mean, it's pretty natural. You just punch
unquote,
the
natural,
thing into
like, natural. Like this is.
I mean, blood's a natural occurrence, isn't it? So, you know, just move outside
yeah,
he's the body.
Got a,
but
he's
it's
got
not naturally outside the body and in mist form.
Well, I mean, in fairness, when Murky appears, it kind of does quite often by the looks of things.
Yeah, it's a pretty
it's a natural occurrence for him.
Oh my god, Murky just reduces things to their natural state.
That's my power, not a monk. I'm a fucking, like,
a molecular sinist. Deconstructor.
Yeah.
He's the molecular disassembler.
Oh my god, that's like the best superhero name ever.
Shit, wrestler name, amazing superhero.
I'm going to take over the world by blocking out the sun, and they'll need to pay me.
I've got the ability to control the power.
I don't think you will.
Matt,
who
I
are you? I am the atomic disassembler. What the fuck are you gonna do?
Like, I am the molecular disassembler.
I can
you
take
see that giant thing you built to block out the sun?
Yes.
Gone.
I can turn on like. You are now a person, you are now a jar of pickles.
Oh. Considering
why a jar of pickles?
Because
he can. He reconstructed his like entire genetic structure
no,
to
he's
be
just
a jar of
pickles. He has a partner that's the molecular rearranger.
It's his sidekick!
Atomic disassembler and molecular rearranger.
Oh,
the best superhero psychic duo.
This needs to be a flash animation.
You just reduce them to like, atoms, and then your sidekick makes them into a jar of pickle.
Oh, and like, why pickles? And you're just like, because
it's
I'll
the
eat
only thing I've learned how to turn them back into.
Oh,
I got a really
angry banshee.
Oh, tits.
Oh, yeah, angry banshee.
So I'm now...
Oh, joy.
Me and Grey Mac are no longer under the effects of fear.
The sound
only problem is...
of an angry dragon.
It... Oh, I'm not sure which one you mean. I'm scared. Oh, wait, no, that...
I was never scared to begin with. I just shat myself.
Which means that I can actually... Ask you
the scared brick would just play the brown note for me.
Oh,
that's higher than 13. If it's lower than 13,
wait, what?
Constitution
save. Instant death.
Fuck. I'm dead.
You're unconscious.
Does that mean I lose all my health or
oh,
I'm just unconscious?
Shit.
You're just unconscious.
Like,
it's,
so...
your health goes to zero, actually. But I'm not. But this is the fun part. You old guys are just thinking that I'm going to do that. Are you?
It's because you could. Instant death.
Because
instant
I could.
Instant death.
Because I could. But...
Anything less than 18. Instant death.
But...
Instant death.
Brick, put your health back.
Thank you. I'm sitting here, but like, I look like one of those sad dogs, right? And I'm like, oh, my.
Do a hensy-hensy, touchy-touchy on Murky.
Hello, Wolf. How you doing, dude? Welcome in.
That's how it is.
Why is it touching Murky? It's 19. Going to die.
I don't know what's touching me,
you
but it's touching the right places. Keep
I
going.
I rolled a 19.
Yes, that hits.
That hits.
Uh-oh.
Mm-hmm.
Well, be prepared, because
first
I
first
need...
of all, is it a spell or is it a melee?
It's a spell.
Shit.
Oh, Murky.
Is it a melee spell? Is it
it's,
the one that
actually,
I happened to
actually,
do earlier?
On, I can still do this to you anyway. Just make the action regardless, and I can still do this to you.
Is the one I did earlier that had 3d6s?
No. Hold on. If I'm unconscious, how long's that for?
Minute, probably.
Damn it! That's two turns I missed.
What happened to me?
See all these fucking, like,
anyway,
rolls.
Anyway. Right now, piss.
Nine damage.
And... Ooh, because you
like,
did... Ooh,
nine damage.
Reaction.
Nice, Wolf.
And
this is,
what's that going to do? It's murky.
Nine
right.
damage.
Do you know what I can do, though?
I know I can still Hellish Rebuke once per day, but I don't have any of the information saved for that, but, you know, I wasn't technically hit.
Why don't I see your bar?
Oh my god, the Banshee's like, I have an army!
I can do that, because you made an action against me, and you're within grappling range.
Oh dear.
Dirty bitch.
Do you find what I have to roll to do a grapple?
Murky, for the love of God, it's an undead. Don't do that. That's munging. The worst thing is I'm
if
being legitimate.
If you had sex with a zombie that could think, would it be necrophilia?
No, because it would be reanimated or quote-unquote undead. It wouldn't be a corpse. Undead. It would be a dead corpse. Having sex with a zombie would just
so
be like...
So, let's see, what would I have to roll for a grapple?
It would just be sick and disturbing.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, so's munging, but at least, you know, it can turn around and be like, no, I like it.
Well, at least it's munging, it's a good get-together with your friends.
Oh,
at least it's a social activity.
A social munging gathering? My god.
I told my friend Anna what it meant once, and she... Like, the other day, she came out with... If we can go munging together, it'll be a bonding experience.
You're supposed, in fairness, you're meant to have two people to do it anyway. It's two people and a dead person. M.A. Mungers Anonymous.
Spend the last two key points for this.
They all sort of like walk in, they've just got like brown around their lips.
Is that a, like a last
I have a problem with munging. They're like, yeah, we do too.
No, like grapple action is a,
and then it's like,
a thing any
you want to go to the graveyard to get
their
fuck
I just don't know
yeah!
what you have to roll for it. It's just, I've got an action where if you're in grappling range, I can grapple you and do this to you.
No.
And it's a reaction for when you make an action against
question
me.
Though, as a Banshee, is she not a ghost? Can you not touch a ghost though?
She's already
undead.
Punched fuck
it
out of her, so I think it's a bit late to ask.
Yeah, because I was going to say it means that we couldn't literally hit her.
As long as
anything.
She has a form, I can still do this to her.
Okay.
Regardless of whether or not she's a ghost.
Okay.
Is round form?
I am so good with my fist that I can literally
round
punch
is
ghosts.
Form. It's infinite.
The Ghostbusters need to hire me. See these pissy bastard things? No, I'm just going to punch it out of existence. Who are you? I'm Murky.
This is going to be the first time I get to use this properly, so...
Not
I guess I'm gonna put it into a grapple.
In a non-sexual meaning, but we're all gonna take it as a sexual meaning anyway, because it's hilarious.
Yeah,
do it. Grapple me.
Yes. I'm gonna grapple you. So
she's gonna. She's,
I don't
dude,
know if I have to roll something if it's just grapple.
You're gonna grab her like a bowling ball, three fingers and two holes.
Ouch, my anus.
It's quite the wingspan I'd have to have there.
Oh, just, you know, that.
So
you know, it's, you know, the shocker, it's a little bit like an adaptation of that. Instead of that, when you do that, it's called a bowling ball. It's where you put two up our ass and one, we'll leave it there.
It's like turn the pink one in the sink, but, you know.
Oh.
A bowling.
You know.
So I
thumbs up.
I will say, so the equivalent of it for men is not enjoyable.
So this is a...
Getting someone's thumb shoved down your urethra is not an enjoyable experience.
It has a physical form.
Oh, God.
So I can pin it to the floor.
Oh.
So, remember that thing I did to you ages ago? Where I can make you explode.
What, that you did to me?
Yeah, I threatened you with it ages ago when you tried to stab me.
I didn't try to stab you, I thought about it!
Oh God, so, not this shit again, come on, just let it fucking die!
So, while grappled, I'm pretty sure the monster's movement speed is reduced to zero and it has to...
Break free of grapple.
But more or less at this point, I can just, like, yeah, I'll do this.
Okay, it's called... Press the button so I can...
So, Chris?
Yes?
Oh, sweet Jesus!
It is known as the way of the quivering path. Basically, what Murky just did was finger the life out of
it. What you do is basically... You start making your hand vibrate, and you just beat fuck out of their dick.
He literally just G-spotted the shit out of her. Dead.
But none of them make an action against you with grappling range. You can counter their attack by putting them into a grapple,
and hit
you still
the
take the damage.
So many times that they explode.
Using all your remaining key points, you can then cause their body molecules to vibrate harmlessly onto a command tool, in which they take 10d10 necrotic damage. So...
Wait, necrotic?
Yeah.
She's already dead.
Yeah, they can still take necrotic damage.
Oh, okay.
It's basically
you
like
got two nines and a 10. You got three nines and a 10. Jesus.
Because there's nothing better than nine coming from a German.
Well, at least four times. Well, three there, I know. Right, so the Banshee is dead. I'm still unconscious.
Sort of exploded at this point.
And one of the two wolves is currently staring at my ball sack, being like, oh, look, it's fallen over. Mmm, yum yum. So,
Dire wolf number two is dead. Remember, so Brick, it's your turn.
I'm unconscious. I can't do anything.
You're not unconscious.
I've got a kill streak of
you
three.
You said
so
I
far.
Was.
No, I said I could do that.
No, you said you could kill me. I'm still unconscious, though.
You're not unconscious.
I thought it
was just showing that she has that spell.
Yeah.
So what did you do then in that turn?
I touched Murky.
You filthy bitch. No wonder he decided to vibrate you so hard.
Yeah, filthy buggers. She said she was the one that exploded.
Yeah, dirty bitches.
Dirty.
Yeah, dirty bastard.
I came out of that less satisfied than going into it.
How do you think she feels? She disintegrated.
Exactly. So, well, she got off at least.
Well, there we go. There's a five. On to Le Wolf. That's already. That's the one I hit with 16, first of all, so that's 21 in total, I think, now.
Is it dead?
I hope so, because I really don't want it to bite my nuts.
My turn again.
It's not dead!
Right.
Please kill that wolf and someone help me. It's looking at my Primark jacket thinking I could wear that.
He's basically, Brick, he's looking at you. And he's
Chris
thinking,
just killed a wolf already,
you
so
might
I can go kill that one.
You might make well, a great throw rock.
Could I use Lay of Hands?
I'm thinking the
on...
same thing.
I think Lay of Hands is...
You're lying on the ground nearly dead, and you're just like, damn!
Yeah, you can only use...
It's an ability that you have to use, and you can only get it back
once
after
a
short or long rest.
So you cannot use it right now.
Maybe my fucking goal I barely ever used it, but like...
But that's because it fucking shit on everything.
Yeah.
You didn't need to, because nothing got a chance to actually hit you. And if it did, I gave you little crappy heals just to top you up.
Use the pointy end of my sword and shove it right up this wolf's ass.
Does that mean you have to go behind it? Because that makes it a little bit difficult.
No, you can make it sword swallow.
No, that goes out its ass instead of into... Do you know what? Let's not talk about semantics of how we go in and out of wolf. No, before you say anything, Wolf, you're in the chat, I know you are, stop it.
We're all out of your league anyway.
Anyway.
Yeah,
yeah, because I'm not into jailbait.
He'd even have hard luck with MCI.
You miss.
He's not into emos.
You miss.
You miss, it's a 14 to hit it, I think, is it?
Do I have to kill everything here?
Possibly.
Apparently, Murky.
Okay. I'm going on a kill streak of 5, apparently.
4? 5? 4. Wolf, Banshee Wolf.
Punching it in the face should be dead.
Dear God.
God.
That's body damage. That's red misted.
That's 30.
I think it's beyond death.
It is beyond. that's going to appear in your house next, Breck, a fucking wolf.
Oh, great.
I'm going to use special bonus action.
Lol, wolf's just replied with, what the fuck, Breck?
Motherfucker, take a kick at the ass.
With a 19, and I've already done quite a lot of damage to it, so it's probably keeled over and kicked the bucket.
It's
too.
Dead.
Kill
Super
5,
I was
bitches.
Gonna shout at it. User joined your
channel. I killed literally everything there.
Mom, get the camera! Murky got a quintuple!
He got a quad. No, a quintuple.
He got, I was gonna say quint. I was gonna say quad, too. I was like, oh wait, no, 5's quint. Eh. So,
quintuple
there we go. Quintuple kill.
Can I, like, heal Chris now?
Can you not quote the fact that he wants to skewer me with his sword? Oh my god, Wolf, that's genius.
You can.
You think that's bad? Check out the newest quote, if you can.
God damn it!
I think
we're not in battle, so I can do it as much as I want.
Wasn't it like it's also a plus one? No, you can't do it as much as you want because you've got spell slots to expend, so.
But we're outside of battle.
Doesn't matter. You expend a spell slot when casting a level 1 spell, no matter what you're doing.
I don't use spell slots. I'm a bard.
You use a level 1 spell. You use Grey a spell Mac, slot.
As a bard, you still use spell slots. It's just that they
nobody's explained what spell slots are to me.
I did when I helped you make your fucking character. I sat there and explained it to you.
No,
and
you
just
did
went,
not.
Yeah, yeah. I did. Because I remember going through it with you. And I explained it to you. And you were like, yeah, okay, so that's what that does. I'll write it down. You obviously weren't fucking listening half the time.
The spell slots is, at your level, you would probably have the same amount of spell slots as me for level 1, which is 4. Yes?
At his level, he has 5 level 1 and, like, 3 level 2.
I'm casting spells, not adding new ones.
No, okay, like, hold on.
Okay, Graham, no. Okay, look, you see on the spellbook page, to the right, top right, there's a thing called spell slots used and max. Right?
Yeah.
How many do you have level 1?
4.
Right, yeah. So okay,
whenever
so
you
you've
use
done...
I didn't edit that when I leveled up.
Okay, now listen, whenever you use, let me explain this. When you have cantrips, they don't cost a spell slot. When you use anything that's above cantrip, regardless of your class, if you have things that are in spellbook level 1 and above, you use a spell slot for it. Equivalent to that level of the spell. So if it's level 1, use a level 1
to be
slot,
fair,
level 2.
When you were explaining these things to me, you didn't tell me what to do with it, you just told me what numbers to put
I
in.
I told you what they did.
You told me what numbers to put in the match,
yeah,
but you didn't tell
guys,
me what
guys,
to do with
guys,
it during
guys,
battle.
Guys.
Just ignorant fucking it's, hell. I told you both at the same time.
He's got it, right? You've done Cure Wounds
anyway,
3 times, so you take it down to 1.
When you use spells, you use the spell slots.
It's a,
forget the last one that I did then.
It doesn't matter, because we're pretty much done at this point. It's like,
yeah,
it's quarter past 11, so you're going to get them back next week anyway.
Because what you do is you go for sleep. Evening, sun healer. How you doing, dude? Welcome
and
in.
And I'm going to get me some.
So, we survived the Banshee.
Mm-hmm.
Just because, well, Chris Lee went down before he remembered that he has a near enough full heal. And
yep.
I'm sitting here with half a leg and a missing testicle. Not actually, but I've got half health going on here. So we finished our fight for tonight, I think.
Yes.
We hadn't even made it to the other mountains.
Nope.
We haven't even made it to the fucking fake Hogwarts. This
nope.
This was in the city as we're trying to get rations to head that way where we were supposed to go last week.
Oh my god. City that was burning down.
Brick, do you remember that quote? The one about GTA when you said, "Doesn't prostitution sound better when you try to explain it to a child?"
What was it?
Yeah, read it.
Doesn't prostitute sound better when you try to explain it to a child? What did I say? I remember something about that.
This was like 2 months ago.
No wonder.
No, I barely remember what happened last week. Try and says, "What's a prostitute? Your mother's friends."
Well, I can't say much, but Chris knows what I was going to say there for a second.
Yep.
He knows exactly what I was going to say. Right, so, Miss Pierce,
mm-hmm.
Are you up for more, or are you wanting to stop, as it is your campaign? It is up to you.
I'm pretty tired.
Okay,
right,
that's not a problem. What we will do is we shall go on a break, guys. For the YouTube, this is the end of tonight's, or this week's episode. Keep checking.
Next week, well rested.
Next week, yeah. On Brickslayer D&D. Piercy
because
will
next
obviously.
Next week is going to be a level week.
Oh, yeah. There we go. So next week will be level week. So thank you very much for watching for the YouTube video part. So don't worry about that, people who are watching the stream. I will be doing. What are we going to do afterwards? We do some Pixelmon or Evolve?
I don't mind either.
Pixelmon!
I don't care. I'm going to have sex.
Okay.
Nice.
Okay, I need help.
LAN party at your house is over. You were sleeping when everyone.
I can't find one of my cantrips spell list.
CS or Overwatch.
Which one are you
guys looking are going, oh,
Blade Ward.
Blade Ward.
We have a
nice
good night,
Miss
Pierce. Thank you very much for playing D&D again. I appreciate it.
Okay.
Good night.
People want to do Pixelmon, and people are saying Overwatch in the chat.
User disconnected from your channel.
Wolf saying Pixel. I think we're going to be doing some Pixelmon. What we can do is tomorrow night, because the D&D night is quite a long one, to split it up. What we'll do tomorrow, we start with Overwatch from half eight to half ten. We'll do Overwatch then for the first sort of half, and then we'll switch over to Pixelmon again. How's that sound?
That's cool.
Nice.
Sounds good.
Right, what I will do is I shall put on some music for you guys, and no, stop that before it decides to, like, mute my stream before I've even got this.